Kangaroos. No love, no feelings, I choke on the air I'm breathing.
EPW Explosive Pro Wrestling and SHWA, the Southern Hemisphere Wrestling Alliance, proudly present World Collide! Our opening contest is a singles match set for one fall.
The venue is Freo.Social for the first time, completely sold out. This is Worlds Collide, the very first ever co-promoted show by Explosive Pro Wrestling and the Southern Hemisphere Wrestling Alliance. Thank you so much for joining us for the action. My name is Dean Olsen. Joining me on commentary tonight is none other than Mr. Eric Mack.
Thank you very much for having me, Dean. As always, I'm Team EPW, and let's throw over to who this dude is.
That's right. We have got Alex Woden, who you may know from the commentary of the Southern Hemisphere Wrestling Alliance. Alex, mate, thank you so much for joining us. It's great to have you here with us.
It's an honour and a privilege. It's actually a dream come true to see this type of night happen. EPW SHWA, it's going to go off, and I'm going to love being here with you fellas.
That's right. There is unity. There is division. There are versus matchups, and there is a complete sold-out crowd that is here for it all. And we're kicking it off with some singles action here right now. Making his way to the ring is Antonio Corrado. And, of course, he's up against a newcomer here to explode. Oh, can we not forget Mr. Thompson?
No, you can't. And very importantly, the most important rule here is no hat, no play. Antonio Corrado is covered in more ways than one.
That's right. I'm usually one to wear a hat, but not on a night like this. And, of course, as I was about to mention, Mikey Broderick is the opponent. He has made his way over from the east side and is going to be spending some time with us here in Western Australia. He has a great and long, very impressive history in Australian wrestling, which I'll run you through when the match kicks off. But this one is going to be a good one. Now, Alex, we've seen Corrado in both companies. What do you know of the man?
Well, he is the Macedonian muscle man. He is chiseled out of marble. Him and Mr. Thompson, brains, brawn, total package. Mikey Broderick's in company tonight.
I'm not too sure about that, Alex, because Mikey Broderick might be a newcomer here to EPW and SHWA events, but he has forged an absolute heart wherever he's gone in this great country.
That's right, it's the mind and muscle connection on one side. They are lost interest in Corrado, though. As I said, Mikey Broderick, he's been a pro since 2008, so well over a decade worth of experience, coming all the way from Squat City. He is the king of squat style, and of course he's wrestled all around Australia, you name it, Wrestle Rampage, PWA, MCW, he's been there. He's also been a PWA heavyweight champion before as well, and there you go, doing the squats.
The fans enjoy some good leg day, but Antonio Corrado is not here for it.
No, he's not. That's how all this started. It was at the EPW School of Pro Wrestling that Karada was talking down a bunch of trainees, and then Broderick rocked up and got his face. Said, and I quote, "You looked a lot bigger on Instagram."
If you're going to burn someone these days, that's how you do it, my friends. Ooh,
mate, let's be honest, both men are absolute specimens.
Yeah, absolutely. So it's unfortunate for Antonio Corrado that the specimen that he is has to go against the alpha specimen in Mikey Broderick.
Don't worry about that. He's got Mr. Thompson in his corner. Mr. Thompson may only be a PE teacher, but the man is still smarter than everybody in this building here tonight.
Well, look, that is a double-edged burn.
I was going to say, far be it from me to call myself smart. Broderick puts on the brakes. Oh, there you go. Oh, doing some steps.
Oh, there's the step-ups.
Oh, you love to see it, of course. Broderick goes under, off the ropes now. Karate, no. Brakes put on by Broderick. Oh, assisted squats now. This guy can do it all.
So this is squat style, is it?
This is. He is the king of squat style. Huge hip toss. He's also an affiliate of TMDK, a brand that everyone's very well known. Ooh. Everyone knows very well here in Western Australia. Also, he has plied his trade overseas, has Broderick. He's been seen in Osaka Pro in Japan as well as 01. He's also done stuntman work with Universal. How's that?
Doesn't need a stuntman there. Takes Corrado to the other side.
Here you go now off the ropes. Corrado goes under. Nice leapfrog. Broderick hits the deck. Corrado again. Oh, straight into a picture perfect, beautiful dropkick.
All right, that's what squats can do for you, my friends. What a dropkick.
I think the crowd wants him to do a squat whilst he has Corrado in a fun. There you go.
Corrado was not a small guy. That's an impressive feat of strength there from Broderick.
That is. I might be a rookie at the gym, but that's a fair bit of weight he just squatted.
Don't sell yourself short. That Progress 365 is showing its worth there, Mr. Olsen.
Thank you, bro.
You are looking nice and taut, Mr. D-Moon.
Oh, thank you. And here comes... No! Fakes him out. Oh, some push-ups. Great form as well.
I feel as though if you can get a circuit and a CrossFit class into a wrestling match, that's going to double your efforts there when you wake up in the morning. And oh! I was going to say with that puffed up chest, but Corrado's going to have a puffed up chest for other reasons now.
That's right. Broderick, he's been in an EPW ring for about 2 minutes now, and the crowd is absolutely lapping it up. Meanwhile, Mr. Thompson, didn't take him long to get involved in this one. Oh, down he goes.
There you go. That's the advantage of having Mr. Thompson at ringside. Mikey Broderick cannot take his eyes off that man for 1 second.
And that's the advantage of having referee Matthew Clark stuck to the side of the ring. He had an eternity there to stop Mr. Thompson. You've got to wake up, get some of these energy drinks into him.
Look, we can criticise the referees all night, I'm sure. Corrado, though, with a blatant choke on Broderick there on that middle rope.
Corrado is a man that takes his opportunities. We saw him have a shot at the EPW. Oh!
He's picking it on!
Yeah, we got a bit of slip, slop, slap action. Goes well with that headband.
That is opportunistic, but yes, former contender to the EPW Championship, blindsiding Julian Ward earlier in the year.
Yeah, that's right. It was our first EPW show of the year, Hot Summer's Night, where Karate got himself a shot at Julian Ward, the first person to have crack at his EPW title reign. That championship will be on the line in the main event of this show. Many championships will be on the line throughout this show. Huge throw there by Karate, though.
Yeah, Karate showing his power now. Broderick had his turn. Now Corrado's going to show him.
Well, speaking of Instagram, that's the time where you spend more time worrying about what the camera person is doing, getting a nice shot, than actually executing a successful cover. Bit of a rookie error there from a very talented individual.
That's right. Hopefully the cameraman at ringside is getting all the right angles.
Pick up my angle earlier.
Going to need a lot of filters for that.
Oh, look out, look out, look out. We've got ourselves beautiful stalling vertical suplex there by Antonio Corrado.
He does show a lot of poise for a very inexperienced competitor. I mean, if you've got someone coming in like Mikey Broderick, you wouldn't be against Corrado if he had a few nerves, but he seems pretty calm and collected.
That's the risk, though, between confidence and being cocky. Hopefully Corrado doesn't go across that line, though.
Nicely done there by Broderick. Crowd firmly on his side. What a great way to kick off a historic night. Ooh! Runs straight into that back elbow by Corrado, though. Comes off the ropes now. Oh, just gets wiped out. Back up for more and another back elbow strike.
For a man who loves his squats, he's definitely got an upper body to throw those forearms with a lot of force.
Oh, look out.
Is he going to skin the cat?
Yeah, he is.
I guess he doesn't miss chest day either.
I don't think he misses any day at the gym, let's be honest. And look out. Here goes Broderick!
Whoa! Great agility from the big man. Takes out Corrado. Now, oh! Mr. Thompson off to detention for you.
Broderick now on the top rope. High cross body! Oh, Corrado lucky to get a shoulder up. This one will continue. Not over just yet.
Any higher, we might have lost the deposit on this venue.
Can't have that. Got to make a good impression here on our first night. Oh, jawbreaker there.
And what a first night it is, Dean Austin. This place is sold out. We got 300, 400, 500 people in the crowd. This is awesome.
Absolutely fantastic and great to see. It's good to be back. And oh, Broderick, wait, no. Corrado goes underneath.
Here he goes, torture rack.
Torture rack time. People want him to do a squat.
Yeah, do a squat.
Can he do it? Can he do the squat as well?
Might not have time because Broderick's trying to get out of this predicament. Oh, there you go.
Didn't need the squat. A lot of impact. Goes into the cover now. Ooh. A two count. Could have been three with a little bit more body pressure there from Corrado.
That's right. Like you said, you spoke about the inexperience. Corrado has not been... Wait a minute. Did Mr. Thompson just slip something, some foreign object to Corrado? Is that a... Is a whistle?
It's a whistle. Is that gimmick infringement on Bruno Nitro?
It could very well be.
Referee Matthew Clark not having any whistle, but this is the least of Broderick's concerns.
Mr. Thompson, just hammered Corrado with that whiteboard.
School's out for Antonio.
Oh, we're going to see it, lads. Looks like he's lining up for it.
What's he doing?
Oh, I think I know what this is. It's the anabolic elbow! Nailed to perfection. 1, 2, and 3. That's it. Mikey Broderick gets a win in his first match here in WA.
That was a nice-looking elbow. I'll give him that much.
An impressive outing there from Mikey Broderick. And already we can see the jam-packed Freo.Social in love with this man.
Look, what's not to like? Let's be honest. Huge first outing here in, well, we haven't seen Broderick in WA for quite some time. But the fact that he's going to be sticking around, I'm all here for, and so is the packed out audience here tonight.
What a way to start this place. It's pumping. So is Broderick.
Finishing up with some squats.
We're all lucky to see that without having to pay for a subscription.
So EPW doesn't want us fighting any of their blue bloods on May 7th, or showing up at their events anymore. Apparently, we cause too many problems. So at Worlds Collide, myself and Jared Slate will be challenging for the SHWA Tag Team Championships.
Battle 64, we are the longest reigning Tag Team Champions in SHWA history. And we want our belts back. Take me high and I'll single you. Make everything okay, okay, okay.
those belts. They're coming here tonight to regain them. Metal 64 are in trouble tonight. Dean Olsen, you know these guys very well.
Yes, I do. I'm an Australian and Indian competitor. I've seen them work previously in Explosive Pro Wrestling as well as the Southern Hemisphere Wrestling Alliance. They are the challengers for the SHWA Tag Team titles here tonight, my friends. And this one is not going to be for the faint-hearted.
Yeah, not at all. And it's nice to see these two actually come through the appropriate entrance for a change here at an EPW event. They've been causing chaos for the last couple of shows, putting their faces where they're not invited. Very talented tag team, but just not so welcome here in an EPW ring.
And let me tell you something, E-Mac. What we do things in SHWA, we find a way or we make one. That's what they did.
Well, as you said about chaos, chaos is what these two are all about. But I tell you what, it's no easy day at the office because they're up against the tag team champions and these guys have been on a hell of a roll as of late.
Couple tag teams in the dictionary, you'll find a picture of these two gentlemen. But against all the odds, anybody, they didn't think these guys could be worth a damn. If you look at the SHWA tag team champions, and by God, I'm proud of these two gentlemen.
Yeah, they've been doing some great things. It took them quite a while to find their feet, but boy, did they find them. They've been doing big things all around WA. They got a win at EPW Dead or Alive last month, a hell of a win at that. But more recently, they've become the SHWA Tag Team Champions, winning them back on October the 30th of 2021. It's a team that keeps going from strength to strength, and it's going to be a hell of a challenge for us here tonight.
It's going to be a hell of a challenge, but these guys have shown that they are championship quality whenever they go right now. Of course, the SHWA Tag Team Champions, more title defenses than the longest reigning challengers. And they've also beat the current EPW Tag Team Champions, Cutthroat and then some, at Dead or Alive.
Go to George Hamill for the announcement.
This is the Southern Hemisphere Wrestling Alliance Tag Team Championship match. Introducing first the challengers standing directly in front of me. They weighed in at a combined 5 SHWA Championship run, 4 mid-year rumble wins, and former longest reigning SHWA Tag Team Champions. They represent all of West Australian Pro Wrestling. This is the team of Felix Young and the current SHWA Pro Champion, Jared Fleck.
Divided crowd here this evening for this tag team matchup where the SHWA Tag Team Championships are on the line. Metal 64 up against the Pulse. Oh, and a blindside by the Pulse. I should not be surprised.
No, this one's going to be an absolute barn burner of a fight. Man, there's nothing subtle about the Pulse.
I shouldn't be surprised at all that these two would attack from behind. Going for the quick cover.
And they could have been up very, very quickly, but...
We have Jordan Bishop in front of us, convalescing and leaving Ryan Allen to fight the good fight by himself. Oh, cops a knee to the face.
elbow strike to the back of the head, followed up by a high knee lift there by Felix Young. These guys are not messing around at all, as they said, and it was said in the introduction. They are the longest reigning SHWA tag team champions that have ever been. It's been some time since they held the tag team gold, and oh, the way they're going at it here this evening. Oh, they're ready to have another go at it. Of course, they have a lot more experience as a tag team as well than Metal 64. We mentioned when they made their entrance, Metal 64 really weren't on the same page for a very long time, but they've gotten it together as of late. But I guess that experience edge to the pulse is playing a big part in the early goings of this one.
Yeah, absolutely. And the thing is, though, current form, winning form is good form, and you can't take that away from Metal 64 racking up wins. So I can see why the pulse wanted to jump them from the start, because with the SHWA Tag Team Championships on the line, a long history, a long legacy.
Now this match boils down to, for Metal 64, is their finishing move game over. If they hit it, it's game over for the Pulse. If they don't, it's game over for them, end of their title run.
Might be game over for Ryan Allen's chest just about now.
Oh, it's about as red as his hair. We've got Jared Slate now in the ring. This is a man that's not only a two-time SHWA champion, he's the current Pride champion, been a tag champion twice before. Oh, a poke to the eyes. He's also a former EPW Tag Team Champion. And one thing I should point out, I was at the very first ever Southern Hemisphere Wrestling Alliance show. At that show, Jared Slate was wrestling there. He is still a part of the roster all these years later. This is a man that's been with this company from the very beginning.
Jared Slate isn't just a part of the company, he is the company. He built this place, Dean Olsen.
If he's so proud of SHWA, I'm not sure why he keeps trying to encroach on EPW events and try and make his mark there.
Oh, now, guys. Keep it in the ring for now. We can get at each other later on in the night. Felix Young with a hook of the leg. Not enough to get a three, though. Referee Mastin trying to keep Jordan Bishop in check. I think he needs to look to the other corner.
Ryan Allen slowly making his way up. He really needs to create some separation and get the healthy man Bishop into the ring.
Speaking of Bishop, one thing I've been very, very impressed with him lately, ever since teaming up with Ryan Allen, the fire that he's shown, the intensity that he's shown, it's come through in his matches, he's more aggressive. He's basically, he's a nerdy ass kicker, and I love every second of it.
Yeah, Metal 64 are one of those teams that now that they've found their groove, they're doing some really big things and really connecting in a way that never made sense for the longest time. And oh, another chop to that poor chest of Ryan Allen. God, he's taken some punishment in this one so far. But it is the tenacity and just not giving up at all of Metal 64, which has got them as far as they have, wearing the gold around their waist, which you love to see.
Yeah, you love to see. But Ryan Allen's chest is starting to look like a beetroot you could get from the Freo markets down the road.
Very good, Amac. Very good. Right now, see, this is not going to win you a championship matchup. Jared Slate knows this, but it's all about the mind games.
It's definitely mind games. Jared Slate, he is not a dumb person. He knows his opponent's backs and fronts. Metal 64 are two of the most resilient young men you'll ever see. Knee operations, neck operations, concussions, cuts, bruises, contusions. Anything you can think of, these boys have been through, and it's going to take a lot to actually get their shoulders to the mat for the 1-2-3.
Yeah, they certainly have been their private health insurer's best friend for a long time, but it's great to see them getting a good run at things right at the top of the tag team mountain of SHWA.
That's why they need to keep at it and not give up like we've seen many times before to get the win over the Pulse here tonight and retain those tag team championships. And a real nice step up in security there by Ryan Allen. I think he's got Slade a little bit rocky. Manages to make a tag to Felix Young on the way down. He's so close to making a tag, but not just yet. Oh, wait, look out. Oh, I thought he was going to kick Mastin in the face. Oh, no, instead Felix Young gets it.
It's an educated fear to Ryan Allen there.
That was a win-win-win scenario.
A few people in the crowd, I think, would love to see Mastin cop it in Zaguri, but nonetheless, maybe another day. Oh! They just rocked Mr. Metal.
Oh, by the old gods and the new, that one just took his head clean off.
Wow. Turned his head into a vice, and that cover there should have been a lot more forceful for Jared Slate to try and get these tag team championships.
I agree. If he'd hooked the leg there, Remac, this one would have been over.
No doubt about that.
Alex.
Slate, though, he's oh, no. No, he's not going to, is he?
Oh, that man's had a broken neck before.
Oh, yeah, but I don't think he's ever had the Rusty Fishhook.
We are in Freo, at the home of the Rusty Fishhooks. I believe that's their baseball team, isn't it?
Oh, I have no idea, to be honest.
We'll have to ask referee Matthew Clark, he's the baseball expert. But Ryan Owen. Yeah, this has to be him right now, eh, Matt?
Could have been worse, could have been Vegemite.
Anyway, Felix Young, now the legal competitor of the Pulse. Going straight back to work on Ryan Allen. He's got him up in a bad position there, hanging in the proverbial tree of woe.
Tree of woe, no man's land. There's no good outcome for this for Ryan Allen coming up.
Not at all.
And we all know Felix Young's a devious, vicious individual, so this could be anything for Ryan Allen.
Still really can't battle out. He's got to get his legs out of this predicament. He needs to make a tag even more so.
There we go, he's out.
There we go.
Needs to envision himself in a circle of death and just get out of there.
Good call. But Slate now with a waist lock.
What's Slate doing in there illegally?
Oh, head first into the crotch of Felix Young. Jordan Bishop is jumping out of his skin at ringside. He wants in this matchup so bad. Oh, nobody home for that one. Ryan Allen, make him. Say, hey, for the love of God. And the tag is made. Jordan Bishop back.
Oh, this crowd just erupted. Jordan Bishop, like you said, the proverbial house of fire. Let's go, son. Put those cheat codes in.
Connection issues there for the Pulse. As Bishop just starts hammering away.
Well, there ain't nothing like a LAN party.
Oh, wow. Miscommunication there by the Pulse. And Bishop is going to make him pay for it. There you go. Head full of steam with Jordan Bishop paying dividends.
Great offense. Two for the price of one. It's like a sale at EB.
Here we go.
There's always a sale at EB. And supersonic speed.
Again. Sonic 2.
Ryan Allen, he's been through hell. Jordan Bishop, though. He's feeling it. Wait, we're going to see some Metal 64 in stereo here. Some
synchronized flying.
Time for some multi-tap action.
Here we go!
Metal 64 feeling like they got God mode turned on right now.
This is why they're the tag team champions. Great unity coming together. And now Felix Young is in the center of the ring with no place to go.
To the face by Bishop. He's got him up. Oh, plants down Young. Metal 64 need to make this count. They need to wrap this one up and get it done. Jared Slate's wiped out on the outside. They've got the numbers on their side. They've got the momentum for the first time this matchup.
Phoenix Flash coming possibly? No.
Elbow drop into the cover. That's one. That's two. Is that three? No. Jared Slate on the outside grabs the leg of referee Clint Maston, which stops the arm from getting to the canvas.
Oh! Ryan Allen leaps to the outside, got elbowed on his way down, and Bishop slides out for some as well, but Jared Slate, oh, surely not. Oh! Powerbomb on the side of the ring!
And everybody knows that's the hardest part of this structure.
Oh, it's even on the corner as well, just for extra damage.
Man, you know that you talked about Ryan Allen's chest before. Look at his back, Danielson.
He is busted up. Now with Bishop wiped out on the floor. Oh, Slate!
Nothing pretty about that, but it sure is effective.
Oh, and again, just blunt force to the face.
Oh, somebody think of the children. Come on now.
Slate, but see, Ryan Allen, that tenacity just keeps on stepping up. Getting back in the face of the challenger. Oh, there you go. Ryan Allen is one half of the SHWA Tag Team Champions.
Lovely spinning kick, and now the step-up ends. Aguirre using those feet to good effect.
That's right. He's bringing the confidence of a champion, is Ryan Allen.
Oh, he's going to hit that Phoenix Splash. I got the high rent district.
It's what everyone wants to see. He's making his way up to that top rope here at Freo.Social. The sold-out crowd loves it. Oh, no!
Young cuts him off at the pass and now enters the ring legally.
Oh, this is very, very bad. We have new SHWA Tag Team Champions, the Pulse, ladies and gentlemen. What a match, what a fight. Metal 64 took the tour. Now I'm slightly short though.
We have seen the championship reign of Metal 64 come to an end. And once more, the team of Jared Slate and Felix Young have
got the Southern Hemisphere Wrestling Alliance Tag Team Championships in their hands.
I haven't disliked Paul so much since the last time I was at Metro Freo.
Very nice E-match. It was our first championship matchup for the evening, and the titles have changed hands.
It looks like Brian Allen's hurt, boys.
Brian Allen.
How could you not be after that devastating finishing maneuver from the Pulse? Combination at the neck.
Right, he is in a bad way. Metal 64 took a lot of punishment in that one. We've got ourselves new champions.
Look how classy they are. They've injured their opponent in the middle of the ring, and there they are dancing with the belts around him.
Hey, Metal 64 knew the risk, my friend. Brian Allen had that surgical repaired neck. They went after it. New tag champs, there you go.
But they've been gracious in victory and gracious in defeat, and that's something that your SHWA guys are going to have to figure out by the end of the night.
Well, we will see. This is the first of a number of championship matchups we've got in store for us here tonight. We'll wait and see what happens later on this evening.
So it's finally happened. Mikey Broderick, the squat movement, has come to WA and has arrived at EPW. You know, it's been a long 2 years, the borders have been shut, but finally, fitness is here, fitness is strong, and squat forever, because Mikey Broderick is EPW.
Mad Mikey Nicholls. Australian Sensation Craven. A match no one thought would ever happen. Let the madness
begin. The wrestling world is a wasteland, but it's my wasteland. It's my world, and in my world, I don't even know what a SHWA is. In my world, Craven, you're just another name on a piece of paper. On May 7, when worlds collide, I will run straight through you, and then I will forget you forever. You want to join the madness? You have no idea what you're in for.
Sit down, Mikey. You can shove your elitist bullshit.
Suffocation, no breathing, don't give a f*** if I cut my arm bleeding.
You say you don't know what a SHWA is. You say I'm just another name on a piece of paper. You say you don't even know who I am. Well, after Worlds Collide, I won't have to remind you. You'll simply have no choice but to know who Craven is. So Mikey, I welcome the madness. And I'll see you at Freo.Social.
Who will walk out victorious in this sensational madness? Who will survive this epic battle? SHWA versus EPW, Worlds Collide.
The next contest is a singles match, straight for one ball.
One ball!
Introducing first.
Australian sensation. He is Craven. He is one of the best in this business.
That's right. We are very familiar with Craven's work and explosive pro wrestling. And dare I say, all around this state and this country, he has not been in Western Australia for a very long time. But when Mad Mikey Nicholls threw out a challenge of anyone from the Southern Hemisphere Wrestling Alliance, this man was the last person we expected to answer the call. But here he is, not only back in the Southern Hemisphere Wrestling Alliance, but back in WA itself.
Yeah, respected wrestler inside the ring, outside the ring, very much well-liked by his peers, but not, he does not care about his peers right now as he takes on one of the baddest men in all of pro wrestling.
Representing
a pain in the stomach, and these heartbeats turn to fat lines. You better start running, I can hear the battle drum coming. I can hear the battle drums coming.
Well, let's have a look at these two studs go at it. This is going to be for bragging rights, for supremacy. I'm looking forward to these two go at it.
The bell has been rung. The match is officially underway. And I know it is a tired and brutally beaten cliche, but a main event anywhere in the country is this match right here. The Australian Sensation Craven up against Mad Mikey Nicholls. These two, I never thought that I would see this happening, let alone under the banner of both companies they represent.
I'm literally getting goosebumps right here, gentlemen. Look at my arms, goosebumps city. Now we talk about well-traveled. These two men have been everywhere, every continent, every country. They've been there, done that. It's going to be a hell of a show, man, hell of a match.
Speaking of travelling, Mikey travelling to the outside of the ring to get closer for some fan interaction at the beginning of this one.
That's right, and soon to be travelling to the United States of America to represent New Japan Pro Wrestling, where he is not only representing TMDK, but also representing Chaos. He's a man who has held championships in Japan as well. Craven, very well travelled around the world too. These are two world-class athletes and amazing pro wrestlers. And this sold-out crowd in attendance is in for one hell of a treat.
You see here, this is a two-team town, and that's all the more appropriate. Oh, no! We'll have to check if that turnbuckle is regulation. That's why Mikey Nicholls doesn't go to the top rope often.
That's an EPW turnbuckle, I might add.
Yeah, Judas!
Maybe Craven's gotten a little bit in the head of Mikey Nicholls. He's played very cool in the lead-up to this one, throwing a little shade on the socials as well. Speaking of, don't forget to follow both companies on all forms of social media. We are all over Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Give us a follow for all good stuff, much like you're seeing right here as both people locked up. Con elbow tap. Neither man backing down. Ooh, Craven lucky. Dodge that bullet.
Yeah, that one well scattered. Don't call him Mad Mikey for nothing. You've got to watch those things.
And that might have been collecting his head on Parry Street if he connected with that.
Might have landed right in the watermelon stand at the markets, you reckon?
Ooh, maybe. Of course, should point out, Craven, a former SHWA champion, and Mikey Nicholls, former two-time EPW champion, former tag champion as well. Both men have been... held many championships in this great status. Craven just letting Mikey know who he's in the ring with.
Yeah, disrespectful slap, and it also rocked Mikey there for a moment.
Clancy got his tights pulled and his hair pulled, perhaps.
Yes. That's a very versatile slap.
Yeah, slap will do that to you.
All right, here we go, both men are locking up yet again. Side headlock in tight by Mikey Nicholls. This man, of course, as you pointed out, EMAC, held the EPW Championship for such a long time, has only tasted one defeat since leaving World Wrestling Entertainment. Well, I'm not gonna repeat what he just said.
Here we see, it's a source of pride for both men. No one taking a backward step. Oh, lovely shoulder block from Craven and doubles the dose.
Now these guys are very evenly matched. You'd say probably the power game goes to Mikey, but the speed and agility goes to Craven. This one's a pick'em, gentlemen. Whoever makes the last mistake will lose.
That's a very good point there, Alex. Craven, though, clotheslining Mikey to the outside. And that is one thing that we do have to keep in mind, is that Craven is very well known for more agility, more high-flying offense. Mikey, though, certainly has the power game.
One step ahead of him there was Craven. And the interesting thing in the entire build-up to this match, me and Dean and Alex, is the fact that Craven has been very respectful of EPW. You've got to hand it to him. He has been very appreciative of this opportunity to go against one of the best this country has ever produced. But Mad Mikey, he's got no love for SHWA.
No, well, we respect Mikey Nicholls. Don't get us wrong. We know exactly what he's done, what he's all about. But, hey, we don't give two dams about that man. He can say what he wants.
Well, it's all about... It's all that promotion pride, no doubt about that. Don't get me wrong, the show is under both banners. When it comes to matches like this, you gotta pick a side, am I right?
You have to pick a side, and I will obviously be Team EPW until the day I die. Although Mikey is about to get that hand manipulated after missing with the fist drop.
Oh, this is gonna be... Okay, he's calling for a bit of hush.
Oh! I cringe every single time he does that.
Well, if someone strikes as hard as Mad Mikey Nicholls, it is a wise strategy from Craven to try and take the hands out of the equation.
That's right. He's not going to be dishing out any of those hellacious knife-edge chops. You've got broken fingers, and I tell you what, there's a solid knife-edge chop to give Mike a run for his money.
That's a good old open-hand slap from Craven. I think he learned that in Mexico.
See the ring moving, hence is the velocity that Craven is working with at the moment. Just a one count, Mikey, just up and about. You can see him starting to get pretty agitated with the situation he's found himself in as Craven is a step ahead.
Well, one thing that you mentioned, EMAC, is that, like you said, Mikey has no love for the Southern Hemisphere Wrestling Alliance. Maybe he's underestimated Craven just a little bit.
That's going to be to his detriment because Craven, like we said, has been everywhere. He's wrestled everybody, every style. There's not a man in this planet that Craven will not wrestle. But the thing is, Craven does not underestimate anybody.
No, he doesn't. He is well-loved all around this country. If you've been anywhere near any social media, whenever anyone says, hey, who would you like to see me face, this man's name is always in the conversation. And he just knocked Mikey outside and down to the hardwood floor of Freo.Social.
See, the crowd's starting to get into it. As I said before, they've picked a side for the Knights, and hopefully they're on the winning side.
Oh, that's not a winning side. Craven just got his chest caved in by one of Mikey's patented chops, like you said, Dean Olsen.
Oh, there you go. Great acoustics here at Freo.Social. I tell you what, I've seen so many bands play here. It's a different thing hearing someone get the life chopped out of them.
Well, that is music to everyone's ears except Craven's at the moment.
Yeah, no doubt about that, as he's looked like, oh, he's about to get another one. Thought he was going to put the brakes on there. Oh, no, wait, Craven. Maddie up for more, and no, that one's gonna hurt.
Well, everybody knows when flesh meets steel, flesh loses, and that wasn't just flesh, that was Mikey's pair of TMDKs.
That is true. Good thing he's already a father with one more on the way, because could be closed for business there.
So you don't need them then. Well,
nonetheless, we've got Craven back in the ring. Mikey on the back step, very rare sight.
Well, he just got hit in the janglies, mate. Of course he's going to need some time to breathe.
Hit in the janglies. He went nuts first into a repost.
That was what they call yambag yahtzee, my friends.
Oh, my goodness.
And I think you don't tug on Superman's cape and you don't ram Mikey's nads into the post because he is mad right now.
That is not a catchphrase I've heard before.
We'll get it on a shirt at wrestlermerch.com. Thank you very much.
Yeah, well, okay, we'll stay tuned for that one nonetheless. Oh, referee!
Come on,
Mastin is getting hurled to the far ringside. Might want to get the hell out of Mikey's way.
I'm very glad this is
clothesline Dan Muir out of his boots goes Craven!
He clotheslined him Dan Muir out of our boots.
Oh my goodness.
I'm very glad that this is a night where you can fly the flag high for your team and your promotion, and it feels so good to be again cheering for Mad Mikey Nicholls. We've seen the attitude change when he was into his EPW Championship run. So, whilst he might be a bit devilish outside the ring, no one can debate the in-ring expertise of Mikey.
That's right. Mikey Nicholls is as good as it gets in the world of professional wrestling. I will not take anything away from Craven, but Mikey Nicholls is a man that has just worldwide made his name be known, and for a good reason. It's what we're seeing in this matchup here tonight at Worlds Collide.
Yeah, Mikey Nicholls is a no-nonsense competitor. Anybody who's watched him wrestle can see that. Very, very dangerous man indeed.
No nonsense, exactly.
We're here for no nonsense all the time, and that's a lovely shot on that one. What we must say about Craven...
What we must say is he's just getting even more tattoos in what little space he has left.
He's going to say his resilience is a strong point. He's going to have to call upon every bit of it right now.
Mike now just taking a bit of time to admire his handiwork. Crowd here, EPW chat erupting. I'm trying to call it down the middle, lads, but I got to say, I've been with EPW for 15 years. I'm trying to toe the line, Alex. I'm sorry.
Well, I don't fault you for that, mean Dean Olsen. I really don't, because everybody loves their team, whatever colour they end up bleeding, metaphorically speaking, of course. But
well, we should point out Mikey's wearing blue, Craven's wearing green.
Well, Craven's wearing some red as well at the moment on his back after those hard chops and those strikes. It appears as though that Craven's going to want to get to those hands of Mikey again, otherwise it's going to be very quickly curtains for him.
Well, that's the thing. If Mikey Nicholls underestimates Craven even 1 minute, Mikey Nicholls will be wearing an L.
I was going to say, the food here at Freo.Social is pretty good. I'm not sure why he's taking a bite out of Craven.
Pretty good. The food here is sensational. Had myself some duck spring rolls before, but I'll tell you about that during the break. As, oh, Craven luckily puts the brakes on. Oh, and again, wisely scouted. Craven's done his homework. He is a student of the game after all. As Mikey just, hammering the forearms to the side of the face. The Australian sensation. Oh, he turned it around. Dished out a snap suplex.
Yeah, beautiful counter by Craven. Craven is a student of the game. He knows the ins and outs of everybody he faces in that room.
Also an accomplished author. You can check out online. He's penned the book.
Yeah, so I think a couple of copies of it there at the merch desk, which I'm sure that's going to fly out like hotcakes. It's a very interesting story, Craven, and it's well worth the read.
That it is. A lot of love for Craven. Oh, big back cracker.
This could be it, boys.
Oh, Mikey kicks out. Keeps himself in this matchup and keeps Explosive Pro Wrestling in the contest.
Craven thought he had him there for the three. A bit incredulous.
Craven, if it was three, the bell would have rung. You've got to stick to the task at hand, and that is Mad Mikey. When you've got him down, you've got to capitalize.
Oh, he's going straight back to it. Irish whip to the corner. Mike's back hits those turnbuckles and the entire ring shakes. Here we go, waist lock now. Oh, DDT!
Oh, that was gnarly. He just buried Craven's head right in the EPW logo.
Craven gets the shoulder up, though. This one is not over yet.
One of the things that people don't recognize about Mikey is just how quick he is. The transition into that DDT caught everyone off guard.
Well, Mikey's, like, he's an incredibly large man. And I think people do underestimate the speed and agility that he does have for a man of his size.
It's great muscle reflex. That's what it is. His tendons are so taut, and he knows exactly what he's doing in that ring. He knows what he's going to do before he even does it.
Good call, Dr. Woden, as right now we've got Craven in a very bad position, perched up on that rope. Looks like Mikey might be ready to dish out a superplex to the Australian sensation.
Up and over! Superplex right in the middle of the ring. Instinctively, Craven just bounces up there when the pain takes over as he crumples into the ring.
Yeah, Mikey felt that as well, boys. He's clutching that back. He's got to crawl over to Craven, make that counter. Make the cover, I should say, sorry.
That's right. It is high risk. Sometimes high reward, but they call it high risk for a reason. Mike, face to face with Craven now. Both men feel it as they're all up on their feet. Forearm strike by Mike.
It's gut check time, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, my.
That would not look out of place in New Japan, that strike.
That's right. Matt dishing out a bit of chaos. Oh, Craven, though! Speaking of!
This is men's business now, gents.
That it is. This is what everyone wants to see when it comes to worlds colliding. Buster by Mad Mikey!
And dives straight into that. Oh, that vicious lariat! Is that it?
Oh, one count.
Craven kicked out at one. You've got to be kidding me. The look on Mikey's face says it all. Get out of town, the Australian sensation, letting Mikey know he's not done yet.
I said, is that it? Almost just to create dramatic effect. I thought that was it, but one count for Craven. And now up and over into, could be going for a German suplex.
Oh, wait, tag down. He's going to catapult. The mad one, he goes face first into that turnbuckle.
Craven looking to capitalize.
Oh, wait, rolls through sunset flip. Mike's back on his feet. Oh! Great agility there by Craven. Gonna go for a get here. Oh! Destroyer!
This is it, James. Here we go.
I think this might be it for Mikey.
Oh! Millimeters in that one.
That was the closest of closeness. Man, I'm shaking now. This match could go down to the wire.
That is about as close as it gets. The Australian sensation, Craven, he is all stung up. His body just a mess of redness and calluses from all the strikes of Mad Mikey Nicholls, but he's not done yet. He's back up on his feet. He's ready to keep going, but it is our boy EMAC, Mikey Nicholls. He's laid out in the middle of the ring over those three letters that he's fought so hard for, and he's looking like he's in a bad way.
Especially and for the king of the Swanton squad.
That's right, he's up on the top rope. Wait, there he goes. Oh, referee Maston got kicked by Mikey onto that turnbuckle, kicking Craven off the perch.
Where's the DQ? Come on now, is this guy an EPW referee?
No, look, he's just not a very good referee.
Well, he sucks, man. Come on, man, DQ him, don't push him.
Wait.
He's toeing the line here, he's letting Mike know.
Standing up for himself.
Screw standing up for yourself, DQ him.
Oh!
And let's get the win.
There you go. Wait. We don't want to see a disqualification or a no contest. We want to see a winner. Swanton bomb by Craven!
Oh, that could be it!
Two! Oh, did he get him? No!
No, he did not. Mikey kicked out at the last second.
Shut the front door, you boys. That was three.
That was nearly three, but that wasn't quite three. You know Maston would have counted the three after the stick he just took from Mikey Nicholls.
Can Maston count to three?
He can. I've seen it happen before.
Take nothing away from Craven, but Mikey almost done lost it for himself there, getting involved with the referee. Someone the caliber of Craven, you can't be distracted by the official.
No, you can't, but Mikey's down. He's laid out, I think. Yeah. This match is Craven's for the taking. We could see EPW taking the first L at Worlds Collide.
Come on, Craven, put it away, mate.
Got him up. Nicholls with the waist lock.
Oh!
Come on now! That's BS, man.
That is Matty Tabernacle-like here in Fremantle.
That is smart. It's not by the book, but it's smart. And oh-ho! Mikey bomb! That's it! Mikey Nicholls gets the win! And that's a good win for Explosive Pro Wrestling!
Yeah, it doesn't matter how we did it!
Doesn't matter how he did it, when he loads up West Australian Pro Wrestling, he's going to see a win for Mad Mikey Nicholls, a win for EPW, and unfortunately for SHWA, Craven just wasn't smart enough to match up with the Mad One. Smart enough, you EPW folks, all you talk about is respect, playing by the rules, doing the right thing, being above and beyond every other company in this country. Football's that crap.
Sorry, all I'm hearing there is excuses there. Mad Mikey Nicholls, even he's confused by the excuses. That is the man of EPW.
Look, figuring aside, it's all about top shelf pro wrestling.
Absolutely. You're still sucking, mate, but D-Nelson's right.
An incredible match by two incredible wrestlers. Ladies and gentlemen, the Australian Sensation, Craven.
At Worlds Collide, ladies and gentlemen, you're welcome as we are the new Southern Hemisphere Wrestling Alliance Tag Team Champions once again, right, Felix?
Last time we held these championships, we were the longest reigning tag team champions in this company's history. Got a couple belts here, but
two belt slates.
Maybe we should find some more, huh?
More gold.
More gold.
For the first time in WA wrestling history, two worlds collide as the superstars of EPW and SHWA collide for one night only, Freo.Social, Saturday 7th of May.
So, tell us, what are your thoughts?
All I know though, my good friend of the beer economist, is that true Freo people are going to see two Freo champs retain their championships and party like no other, and that no other way is one way only. And how's that, Jules?
Couple of coldies, baby.
Courtesy of our mates at Other Side Brewing.
You know, I've been saying for years that the wrestling world is a wasteland, and if that's all that's left, if that is the best of what you've got, Gavin McGavin, the doomsday clock is down to zero. What you have, I want, and what you have, I will take. Tick tock.
Second action. Made this one.
Somebody won't tell me the world is gonna roll me. I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed.
People waiting, no longer letting any shirt privilege. From straight out Christian Lovers College, he is the heart, well, he true and hard wrestling champion.
Jesse Lambert, he nearly went exit stage right, even though he ended from stage left. Dan Moore, lovely to see you, mate.
Of course, it's Brad's Dan. Dan Moore has to try and control Jesse Lambert. I don't know how he does it, he has a face of stone. Now, this is my first time seeing this young fella, and I have to ask, is he a little different? Version. I like what he tries, and that's the thing. He is an absolute savant and lover of pro wrestling. And from where he started to where he is now, the progress in him has been amazing. But he's still learning, that's the thing. He's still in his alpha, he's never to love the show. And I tell you what, you don't want to be a learner when you're in the ring with the person that Jesse Lambert in the ring with here tonight. Because I know that Jesse Lambert has some challenging things. He challenged for the EPW Tag Team Championships at our last show. He's challenged for the Coast to the Championship in the past as well. But I don't know if he's quite faced someone the caliber of the world beater Damien Slater.
Well, if he beats Damien Slater, he can get rid of the old plate and wear those EPW plates.
Love is a hell of a drug, my friends. And can you blame me, really? Former number one contender for the EPW Championship, coming off a tough loss against Julian Ward. Surprisingly upbeat, because I think in his mind, this is going to be an easy night at the office for Damien Slater. Well, we saw the videos on all forms of social media. It was Damien Slater didn't want any part of Jesse Lambert wasting his time. But then when Lambert said he wants to win over Slater to win his best life, it was about hilarious. And he said, you know what? He's the world beater, and now he wants to be the dream crusher, and he's going to crush the dreams of that little squirt, Jesse Lambert.
I mean, this is what he said to Lambert as well. He said that he hates his haircut. He hates his stutter. He said he looks like Arthur from Hey Dad, and I must
I just, the thing that I found shocking about that video is that that's a haircut. Does he actually go and ask for that? But Jesse Lambert, as young as he is, he won't understand the Hey Dad reference, but he is starting to understand love.
He's understanding love, and Damien Slater understands hatred. Told Jesse just how much he does hate him, how much everyone hates him. He said his grandma hates him, and his grandma doesn't hate anyone. I mean, Grandma Slater is a saint. Bell's rung, we're underway here. Jesse Lambert versus the world beater Damien Slater. This man has traveled the world all around and done amazing things. And Jesse Lambert's a learner.
Jesse was going in for a hug there. I guess, you know, if he does win Amber's heart, he's going to be besties with Slater and Pitt. So, you know, what's a hug between mates?
It's almost like friends by association if he does manage to get himself a chance with Amber.
Well, he may be a learner, but doing that makes him look like a slow learner. TMDK do not want anything to do with this goofball.
David Slater's on another level of most wrestlers, let alone someone like Jesse Lambert. But you have to keep in mind, when the matchup is underway, which it is right now, cotton elbow tie up by both competitors.
Went for the lockup, but it was child locked, it seems.
Exactly. We saw. Did you see what Jesse Lambert posted on Twitter?
I tried to avoid it.
What did he do?
He posted a picture of Damien Slater in the Cruiserweight Classic in World Wrestling Entertainment. A picture of Tajiri kicking Slater's head in, and he put his own head over Tajiri's.
Yeah.
That is some solid shade to throw at a man as good as Damien Slater.
You don't want to, you know, get Damien Slater mad, get him all green misty eyed and whatnot.
That's, you know what, you deserve a thrashing by Slater as well.
Please don't tell him he said that.
I'm going to tell him. I'm telling him for sure. You're in trouble, mate.
There you go, Slater with a heavy flex. These two competitors are worlds apart. Amber is on the outside, but Dan Moore's on the outside for Lambert as well. Of course, he's taking notes and advising all along. There you go, look. He's trying to sweet-talk Amber already.
Did he just say, call me? I'm like, I think the only phone he has is one of those Mike and Jack candy phones.
I think his phone company is Fisher-Price.
That's true.
You guys. Okay, here we are. Back to business. Waist lock. Into a, I thought it was almost going to be a side headlock. These aren't actually holds.
No, he's overthinking it here, Jesse.
Jesse Lambert is playing kindergarten games with a grown man.
That he is, and this grown man is one of the best wrestlers that Explosive Pro Wrestling has ever seen. He's a former EPW champion, former tag team champion, former winner of the Invitational Tournament as well. The solid wrist lock, and that was actually countered quite well, surprisingly enough.
Oh!
And a reversal? You've got to be kidding me. He just reversed the wrist lock on Slater. Get out of town.
Slater says, nope, none of that. Does not want to be embarrassed by Jesse Lambert. Shoves him right into the corner.
Well, he's screwed now because that's all the moves he learned from Dan Moore.
Well, I'm not sure about that. Dan Moore, multi-time tag team champion, Invitational Tournament winner. Dan Moore has a hell of a lot to teach.
He's got a great resume, but like you said, what is the saying? You can lead a horse to water or something like that?
But you can't make it beat Damien Slater.
There you go. Thank you. Thank you for the assist there. Here we go. Lambert with some...
butter knife edge chops.
Yeah. Slater is about to level this learner. Oh, stomp to the feet. And a side headlock. There you go. The technical prowess of Jesse Lambert on display here. Double X-handed misses. Slats hits the jacks and hits for the dropkick too. Lambert puts the brakes on. Is he gonna...
Might be time for Slater to make a wish.
I thought he was thinking of maybe a... Wait, is he going for a clover leaf or a sharpshooter?
It's right.
A figure four? I don't think he knows what he's going for. There you go. Beautiful takedown there by Damien Slater. A man who not only... is amazing at pro wrestling, but he's quite proficient at Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu too. Just tying up Jesse in a pretzel right now. Look at that!
He's going to tie him up in a knot and send him back to Mama Lambert, whoever the hell she is, in pieces.
Look, I was lucky enough to be at Jesse Lambert's grandma buddy. His parents are lovely, by the way. Slater said that his parents hate him. They actually don't. They're lovely people.
They do indeed, but Jesse Lambert mustn't love the predicament now as he gets a... straight boot to the side.
You say his parents love him. They're his adopted parents. His biological ones hate his guts.
Oh, that's rough. Oh, and so is that. Punch to the bread basket, as they used to say in the old school, as Lambert just crawls to the other side of the ring. There is no escape from the world beater, the untouchable, the mighty Damien Slater.
The world beater is so good. He's got his YouTube show, The World Beater Wrestling, and for him to be that good to be able to teach you so many tricks in his arsenal and still have so many hidden.
That's right. If you want to know anything about the goings-on in pro wrestling, or if you want to ply your trade and head to the School of Pro Wrestling, the things you can learn from his YouTube channel are insurmountable.
He'll teach you all you need to know, but he won't teach you all he knows. But I have a question for you two gents, right? Say in some bizarro world, some miracle happens and Jesse Lambert does beat Damien Sutter here tonight, right? He wins the heart of Amber. Is he even going to know what the hell to do with a woman?
Eric?
I'm going to let that one through to the keeper because I'm not sure if that is in the curriculum there from Dan Moore.
Look, he's got to get the win first, and then he's going to try and sweep Amber off her feet. There's a lot of intangibles here.
There's a lot of intangibles, and Amber doesn't seem to want to bar of it at the moment. Having a bit of a conversation with Slater as they try and figure out what's next, and Jesse has not moved.
They always say that nice guys finish last. We're about to find out just how the nice guy trained Jesse Lambert here goes tonight against the likes of Slater. It is almost something out of an 80s teen movie. You've got the impressive, good-looking sports guy who's very athletic, and you've got the, well, you've got Jesse Lambert as well.
But I think what Jesse Lambert's going to find out tonight, that this ain't no rom-com. This is athletic competition, and at the moment, Slater is firmly in control.
Yeah, you talk about 80s teen movies. If this was the Breakfast Club, Jesse Lambert's going to be eating his breakfast with a straw tomorrow morning.
Oh, and there's shots like that, no doubt about it. He just went face first into that green turnbuckle, getting Irish whipped into the opposing one, but he puts the brakes on, managed to dish out a back elbow strike to the face of the world beater. Oh, gets a boot to it as well. Just going to mess up those good looks of Damien Slater there.
Oh, and now the low bridge.
Oh, hey?
The lowest bridge in Perth since the Bayswater Bridge got redone.
Jesse Lambert is building a head of steam here. I think Slater might undersell
him. Oh, no. What's he doing?
He's not doing much.
What the hell was that?
You can see Dan Moore on the outside trying to discourage him from that effort.
Alex Woden, that was an attempt.
Well, I guess we know Dan Moore doesn't know any lucha stuff either.
Well, he was once known as Los Futurador, but that was many years ago.
Another lifetime.
And we don't speak about that anymore. Slater now, with all the confidence in the world, just mocking Jesse Lambert in the center of that ring now. Referee Matthew Clark keeping an eye on things, but it's, oh, look out.
And you got to wonder how much of trying to impress Amber is going to come into this. So he had an opening against Slater, went for the dive through the ropes and missed, so now...
Oh no, he's caught. Slater now, he's... Oh no!
Come on now, this kid's getting luckier and luckier, but there's going to be a moment in this match where Damien Slater's going to just flick that switch and Jesse Lambert's going to be in a whole world of hurt.
Jesse Lambert, oh no, he's giving the thumbs up and Slater breaking into the fist.
Oh man, this kid's special.
It's something else, I'll tell you that.
Oh no!
Irish whip. Oh, Matthew Clark with his shoulder block. I never thought I'd see the day of Jesse Lambert with a head full of steam. Look at him go.
Over that side Russian leg sweep.
Yeah, to no avail. And
Damien Slater misses with the referee assistance. He loves that John Stockton from the referee, and this time it didn't work.
Lambert doing a stretch of the hamstrings. Very smart. Maybe should have done it before the match. Dishes out the side Russian leg sweep, and we were 2 seconds away from seeing Jesse Lambert get a victory over Damien Slater.
Yeah, he almost pooted him away with that side Russian leg sweep.
2 seconds away, also.
Oh, just 2 seconds away.
Just 2 seconds.
It was close, Eric.
At the moment, he's 3 seconds away.
You gotta believe. We're here.
Oh,
no zonks for you. And here we go.
Oh!
Oh, you've got to be kidding me. Spinebuster by Lambert.
Spine on the pine. Where did he get that from?
And it could be time for the most developing move in all of sports entertainment. It's the... Oh!
No, it's not. It's a super kick by Damien Slater right on the jaw of Jesse Lambert. This sold-out crowd here at Freo.Social just...
Two, and that's...
Oh, no, Slater just lifted the shoulder of Jesse Lambert himself.
It's a pity he didn't hit that little people's elbow. I would have liked to see that.
Slater there, though, the story is he's pulled Jesse Lambert up. I don't think Lambert would have been able to kick out, and Slater wants to inflict more punishment and more embarrassment.
Normally, this is not a good move by anyone, but in a matchup where it is so polar opposites, like Slater versus Lambert, you know what? I think Slater just wants to have a little bit more fun here. Not only get a win over Jesse Lambert, wants to let him know that he's not in the league of Amber.
Six!
He nailed it! Is hell about to freeze over?
And
the foot was on the rope.
Oh, he would have got away with it if it weren't for that meddling rope.
Oh, that poor little fella, he thinks he's won.
Matthew Clark letting Lambert know that that was not three. Slater got his foot on the right. Great ring awareness there. The sold out crowd can boo all they want, but this matchup is not over yet.
Not a popular decision at all, but now Lambert bringing Slater into the ring, sensing the opportunity.
You'll notice in between moves and in between things that he does, Lambert keeps turning his eyes to Amber. Here you go. He can't take his eyes off the beauty of Amber, the eye, the object of his affection.
You can't really fault him for that. She's one hot tamale, but you got Damien.
Another one! Dan Moore's just imploring Lambert to make a bloody pin! Wait, he's taking down the knee pad? What is this?
What is he looking for? Oh, no. He's caught.
No.
He's caught in the trap. He taps out immediately.
He tapped out.
He tapped out like a five-year-old on red cordial.
Hey, look, I don't
you
blame him.
Slater's still got that hold linked in.
Slater's not only got the victory, I think he wants to put Lambert out cold. The world beater got the win.
Referee Matthew Clark finally gets Slater off.
Well, look at
what?
Look at the look on Slater's face. He's in a foul mood after that one. Lambert nearly got the better of him.
Well, the thing is that Jesse Lambert, he had eyes for Amber. And Amber was like a sister to Damien Slater. So what do you do if somebody, some googly, pimply-faced loser, tries to make eyes of your sister? You teach them a lesson. That's what Damien Slater did to this little nerd.
Well, Jesse's a learner, but I think he's learned a lesson here tonight at Worlds Collide.
What's Amber doing in the ring at the moment?
I don't know. I think she's
just mocking
Lambert.
Lambert's
still conscious. She's
Dan Moore giving her a browbeating too.
He should feel lucky she's touching him.
Wait, what is going on here? Amber cost him the match.
Oh my.
Uh-oh.
Don't look at me,
This is just a gimmick laptop, mate.
It was him. It was E-Mac.
Slater is furious.
Jesse has got friends in production places and almost dream-weaved his way into Amber's heart.
He Wayne's World this thing.
Well, wee, this is... I've seen some things in all my years, but... There you have it. Jesse Lambert didn't get the win, but maybe, just maybe, he got a little bit of Amber's affection, do you think?
That'll hold him over for a couple of weeks.
Right, EPW, they make the call out. Bruno Nitro can't be here tonight. Oh, what a surprise. That hack, Bruno Nitro, can't hack it at Freo.Social representing EPW. You know what? Chris J. Lazarus, the purveyor of potential. I bleed blue, baby, and tonight you're gonna see it.
Let's go!
Well, I'm surprised you guys are going to have any unity out there at all. You got the traitor Delcano. He is an SHWA guy. He's wearing blue. He's sucking up to Team EPW. He's a little weasel, as Chris Tuggett so adequately put.
Alex, if you actually, you know, took the time to listen to what Delcano said he was very conflicted about this SHWA EPW. He's very respectful of his time in SHWA, and it's very important in his development to make him the wrestler he is today, a former multiple time champion in SHWA and the most recent EPW Tag Team Champion.
Yeah, I didn't hear anything after taking care of what Delcano says, because he talks a lot of rubbish. We don't listen to him. Who cares what he says? He's a traitor, he's a weasel, and he wears that mask, he's ugly as hell.
Well, if one is to level up, you have to step up. And where he is Explosive Pro Wrestling, and that is the brand he's representing. And as you said, recent EPW Tag Team Champion. It was our last show with EPW, Dead or Alive, where he lost the Tag Team Championships. Of course, it was a very surprising turn of events where we had Cutthroat and then some. Almost steal the championships, if you could say.
Yeah, well, they did steal the championships based on the disruption and the distraction caused by the new SHWA Tag Team Champions, The Pulse, as a huge slap to the captain. Oh, Target!
There you go, Target! Launching in. There you go, Lucas Fantasia kicking this one off.
He just slapped a pensioner.
Damn. Okay, this is underway. It is eight-man tag team rules. One fall to a finish. The Great George.
Oh!
Dropkick right on the mush of the Coastal Champion, Aaron Hawke.
In fairness, it's a pretty big target, the bonds of Aaron Hawke.
That is true. He has a very large head. Chris J. Lazarus now just getting wiped out by the Great George. I tell you what, this guy's impressive.
Speaking of heads, you got the head chakra of the Great George. The power resides in the temples, and he's using that to great effect against CJL.
That he is, Chris J. Lazarus, filling in for Bruno Nitro, who unfortunately could not be here this evening.
CJL dumps the former Pride champion, Great George, on the outside of the ring, who decides CJL can join him out there for a little bit too.
He was talking about how smart he was, and then he got the legs taken out from underneath him. Kind of eating humble pie there as CJL is right now. Pint-sized powerhouse, Ryan Rivers jumps off and to the outside, and the sold-out crowd loves it.
Look at the big boy fly.
Wow-wee, this one. I tell you what, referee Maston is going to have eyes in the back and the sides of his head. There's a lot of people to keep an eye out for.
If you have a look at Team SHWA, for the most part, with Target Exuda, it's a young, developing squad. There's a lot to like about the talent that they're bringing to the ring, but can they match with the experience and the powerhouse himself, the Don?
That is a very good point. The experience edge is on the blue team, but the Don now just throws Fantasia over the top rope to the outside. What he doesn't know is that the Great George is waiting in the wings.
Oh, the Macedonian Superman. Looks like he has no effect on the Don.
The Don's back is his kryptonite then, it seems.
He barely moved.
Exactly.
Here we go.
Oh, look out. Oh, there goes the Don. As the Great George swings himself back into the ring. Looks like he's going to... Or is he?
Look at him walking. That's the window washer strut.
Is that what it is?
Oh yeah.
This better not have been that new way of walking everyone was talking about.
Oh, and down goes the Great George.
Oh, George is caught, and now Aaron Hawke pointing to the corner. Surely not. Oh. This is not a man we see go up to the top very often, if at all.
No, it's not. The Coastal Champion. He is known to surprise us every now and again, though.
Are you saying the Hawk can't fly?
Well, look, stranger things have happened as he's right now posing with his Coastal Championship title belt. Meanwhile, they're at the far side of the ringside area. And Exploder off the ropes to the outside. This one is out of control, Emac.
How about the strength from Ryan Rivers to lift the man the size of Aaron Hawke with such careless recklessness onto the pack form below?
That's the powerhouse there, the pocket-sized powerhouse. That dude is Suplex City personified. My God, what a move.
And Fantasia taking this opportunity to check his Instagram likes, it seems. Oh, a little selfie for good measure.
Why not? There's some talent in the crowd.
Here comes Del Weasel.
Delcano. Oh, you dropkick!
Oh, I hope his phone's okay. Lucas Fantasia, do you follow him on Instagram?
Well, I will now. That's some pretty good content, as the kids say.
And now Del Cano going to the top rope.
He's no stranger to flying. And Del Cano's about to fly in Freo.Social.
Holy sugar, honey, ice and tea. My God, what a move.
Del Cano laying it all on the line here for this big inter-promotional battle. And the crowd has become unglued here at Freo.Social.
That they have, the sold out crowd in attendance. Can't believe what they're seeing. It's hard to keep up with. It's harder for us to talk about because this action is thick and fast here as all Del Cano just launches into Lucas Fantasia. Del Cano, the luchador, representing Explosive Pro Wrestling. This is an inter-promotional eight-man tag team matchup here this evening, my friends.
You mean he's a loser-dor? Because you guys are going to go down 1, 2, 3.
It's a terrible joke, yeah, I'm sorry.
I know. Okay. So,
here we go.
Looks like we're getting some semblance of order here as we are getting the competitors migrate to their respective corners. Speaking of corners, Del Cano going up to the top of his again.
As he's going to fly again. Big missile dropkick to Fantasia. Give him a follow on the socials, my friend. He kicks out though. Both teams making their way to the corner. You'll know them by their corners because one turnbuckle has SHWA and the other has EPW.
But we're in Fremantle. Can these people read?
That's why you're the best in the business, Olsen.
Mate, you watch your mouth when you talk about Fremantle.
That's it. We're here in the heart of Flagmantle. Both teams want to get a huge dub, as they say. Oh! And that one was right into the midsection there from team captain Chris Target.
That's the way he's going to lead his team by example. Let's go, Target.
Now, look, I'm trying to call things down the middle. I know, Eric, Mac, you very much bleed blue, and Alex, of course, representing Team Schwa. But I know, Eric, you're a huge fan of Chris Target.
I am a huge fan of Chris Target. Look at the big elbow drop assisted by his vice captain, Lucas Fantasia. Chris Target is one of the most unsung wrestlers in the entire land. It's just the little things he does. He's a grubby person, a grubby competitor, and I mean that in the highest term of endearment.
Now, he's not fancy, but he gets the job done, and that's what counts in this business. We're not here to make friends. We're here to win championships and win matches. Chris Target's done it all.
And Chris Target is, you know, a man with his eye on what's going to be happening with the SHWA Championship picture later on as well. Coming out with that big old trophy. You can tell us a bit more about that, Boyden.
Well, he won the mid-year rumble last year, which gave him the opportunity to challenge for the SHWA Championship, which he did, and unfortunately came up a bit short. But that trophy, as you can see over there, it's beautiful, it's humongous.
It's great.
He carries that with pride, and he's really the king of the Battle Royal, Chris Target.
He's the king of many things, king of the Battle Royal, king of the carnies. He's the king of the monikers, it seems.
He loves a good nickname.
That he does, and the Don is tagged in now. Oh, just leveling Target. Fantasia gets some too.
George and Ryan not wanting any of that.
I don't blame him at all. This man has done it all and then some here at Explosive Pro Wrestling. And the crowd in Freo is here for it. Wait, Aaron Hawk.
Is not here for it.
He tags himself in, as we should know and expect from Aaron Hawk. Short jacket all the way to his own teammates even.
We say it all the time. Aaron Hawk, one of the most obnoxious people in this world. But look at that!
Oh!
The merry-go-round thunder bomb! Oh!
Very few people can get under a competitor's skin the way of Aaron Hawk. But the fact of the matter is that when the bell rings, he can get the job done oh so well inside the squared circle too. Looks like he's laying up for that vertebraker.
That's why he's the champ. He's the champ for a reason. He's the captain of the team. At least in his mind.
Well, that's true. There was a little bit of a misconception about who exactly is the captain of Team EPW. It's not great.
I'm shocked that ego came to play for Aaron Hawk. But now, not taking Ryan Rivers seriously. Now, we've seen Ryan Rivers at the EPW School of Pro Wrestling Showcase events. He's been very successful in there. Former SHWA Tag Team Champion as well, where really was the workhorse of that team as well.
You cannot underestimate Ryan Rivers. He's the most intense pound-for-pound competitor you'll ever see. And he's surprisingly strong. He'll throw you from left to right, top to bottom, inside, outside.
Oh, and there he goes, the pocket-sized powerhouse. Vicious Irish whip into the far corner, and a big back body drop to follow it up. Aaron Hawk is, eating his smugness.
Well, he beats his chest, and over the last couple of years, the physical transformation Ryan Rivers has made has been very impressive. Another up-and-comer who might have to wait a little while with that huge neck breaker.
Yeah, that neck breaker we've seen many times from Aaron Hawk. Tags in CJ Allen, does it with a little bit of stink on it too.
Now, CJL, I've been watching CJL very closely. He seems like an intelligent individual, but how smart can he be on Team EPW, seriously?
Well, this is a man who's bled blue long before many of us who may be watching this show. CJL is as EPW as it gets, as much as he may not like many of the people within it.
No, that's it. He is an absolute worm, but at the moment, he's our worm, and hopefully he'll worm his way to a victory for us.
Your worms are... We spoke about the experience on the EPW side. People, like, don't get me wrong, Delcano's a little newer to explosive pro wrestling. The Don, CJL, Aaron Hawk. Oh my goodness, huge spine buster there. These are men that have been there for well over a decade and a half in explosive pro wrestling.
Yeah, at the moment, they're being met with all that experience of the SHWA guys. Lucas Fantasia, huge upside, but this is like a trial by fire for these two gentlemen.
I tell you what, Lucas Fantasia is very impressive and he's got a very bright future in front of him. I'm liking what I'm seeing from him, but tonight may not be his night with the likes of Team EPW.
Lucas Fantasia is getting blooded here tonight, gentlemen. It's the traditional way of becoming a man, almost.
Somewhat of a rite of passage, because here comes the Don. Just turns the Great George inside and out, but oh, there you go. The King of the Carnies was waiting for him. Chris Target, all business, cleaning the clock at Delcano too.
King of the Kicks at the moment, now going in. Oh, to that Olympic slam.
Got the Don down.
Two.
Don kicks out though. A lot of fight left in this man.
And spare a thought here for Clint Maston as well. I mean, huge legal man syndrome here, trying to keep up with this action.
How the hell is he keeping up with this?
Oh, one? He's doing a magnificent job. And
he actually is. I made fun of him before, but I take it back. I eat my words.
Well, basically, all he has to do is get out of the way and count the pin when there is one.
Hopefully, he's keeping track of who the legal man is, which I believe at the moment is... Did Aaron Hawk target legally?
I'm not too sure, but it was Target and Don there. As I said, it's hard to keep up. It's fast, it's frenetic, it's furious.
Man, I wouldn't worry about who the legal man is. If he sees a pin, just count one. That's all he can do.
Look, it'll work for me, but we've got double teaming here. Lucas Fantasia and Chris Target to Aaron Hawk. Normally I wouldn't mind, but EPW's heart is on the line here tonight.
Look at that forearm from CJL. It's easy to forget with how annoying he is, just how accomplished he is in that squared circle.
But like you said before, this is the first ever co-promoted show by Explosive Pro Wrestling and the Southern Hemisphere Wrestling Alliance. Company pride is on the line in this matchup. There is stakes in this matchup, and both these men know this. What they probably don't know is that the opposing corners, each side has each opponent in a very similar predicament, but wait up.
I know that the craft beers here are good, but am I seeing double?
Looks like some Tower of Doom action.
Oh, in stereo.
Oh, here comes George.
The great George. He has been impressive. I've seen him at Southern Hemisphere Wrestling Alliance shows before. Delcano, I am very familiar with.
Great George and Delcano Spider-Manning it up there.
They're yelling at each other.
Zenith is confused.
I'm confused.
Oh!
There you go, diving headbutt and shooting star press in stereo.
Make the pin, Georgie, make the pin.
I ask again, who's the legal competitor?
They all are.
That's actually pretty good, because I think at the end of the day, you're just going to have to take it when it comes. Great George now going toe-to-toe with Delcano and coming off second best at the moment.
That's right. Macedonia's finest, getting a few European uppercuts from Delcano. Doing the call of EPW, doesn't get the swing DDT, but instead,
oh!
Snapmare driver!
Dirty deeds done dirt cheap right here in Freo.
Oh, I like it. Here we go, the Don now, Death Valley driver! And out goes the Great George!
Before you know it, he's got another man on him, and oh!
Three-handled moss covered! Whatever the hell they call that move, the credenza gimmick, come on now!
And here we go, oh! Rolling a nice by Aaron Hawk, the Coastal Champion, looking good as, speaking about looking good, Fantasia!
Oh!
How about that?
Innovation to the extreme, that was awesome.
The wheelbarrow flatliner there. We need Fantasia to come up with a lovely name for that, because that's a lovely move, but not a lovely predicament right now for him.
We should call it Pretty in Pink.
Purveyor of potential, CJL, gets thrown to the outside by Fantasia. Don now, we know what this is. It is a
choke bomb.
Bomb! Right in the center of the ring, but no! Just got super kicked right to the side of the head.
That's what a captain does, keeps his eyes on the prize.
And he does. Target, oh, with that Olympic slam.
Tajay for the cover, two, we got him, we... Whoa.
What's the call?
We won! We won!
That was about as close as can be.
I think that's three. It was so shocking, so sudden. It's taken the breath out of everyone, except for Chris Target, who chest pumped. Is the winner.
Suck it,
Team S.H.W.A.
Yo.
Credit where credit is due.
Looks like we've got to eat humble pie, E-Mac.
The referee has confirmed that that was a three count for a pinfall. Your eight-man interpromotional tag team winners, Team
Georgie's speechless. He can't believe we kicked your butt, EPW.
Oh, wait, what?
Wait.
Oh, what is CJL doing? CJL has just...
What is he doing? He's just kicked Don Delcano down low.
He's taking the blue off his arm and he has got green on.
I knew he was a smart fella. Smartest man.
Doing takes a loss and then decides to jump ship like the little worm he is.
You wouldn't expect anything less from CJL, but he's turned his back on Explosive Pro Wrestling.
Don't give him a microphone, George. We don't need to hear from him.
Don't. Please, no. We spoke earlier about how long he's been representing EPW and bleeding blue, and now he's doing this. I can't believe this is disgraceful.
He got sick of your crap and he joined the winner team.
Xander's saying the shoulder was up. We had a pretty good view of it. I thought so too, but...
It was down, hippie. The shoulder was down.
He's one of yours.
He's a hippie. Shoulder was down.
Well, it looks like Chris Joe Lazarus has something to say.
Joy.
What you just witnessed was the brand new general manager of the Southern Hemisphere Escalade, leading by example.
Did he just call himself the new GM of SHWA?
That right there is a boss move, my friends.
He's through the match.
You think that means something? You call me Rodney Dangerfield, because I ain't getting the goddamn respect. I ain't getting no respect from these three pissant goddamn letters. So what happens? I go and get my own. Oh yeah, my own playground of potential, baby. That's right. The SHWA is now under Chris J. Lazarus control. You can thank Chris J. Lazarus for World Collide. You can thank Chris J. Lazarus for not having to listen to Bruno Nitro's stupid theme music. You can thank me.
He's a turncoat is what he is.
Again, thank you for this headache I've got right now.
He's a smart man is what he is.
Like right here, the SHWA coming out on top always.
Well, the purveyor of potential, Chris J. Lazarus, announcing himself as the new
super you bunch of pissants, call me your trainer, wear your stupid old plate headbands from your Luther friend Jesse Lambert, while I continue winning matches and being the king I am.
Guess if you can't get it done in the big leagues, might as well go swim in a smaller pond.
Said like a true loser.
Well, Southern Hemisphere Wrestling Alliance did get the win. As I am still shocked at what I've seen here. Chris J. Lazarus has turned his back on Explosive Pro Wrestling. I'm shocked. I'm appalled. I have many things, but there you have it, my friends.
That's right, boys. My team, SHWA, won. That's right, SHWA number one. Chris J. Lazarus always puts his chips where they are. And that's... What are you looking so unimpressed for?
Yeah,
I won your damn match, you pieces of crap. You get out of my sight. Greg George, you're not very great. I'm going to fire you if you don't get out of my sight right now. Get out. Get out. And you too, big boy. How about you big boy your pants right out of here?
Yeah,
get out of here. Yeah, I'll pick you out of here. You take a picture, Fantasia. That's right. Take a picture of the champs. Yeah, that's right. Now get out of here too. I don't want to talk to you.
You're a useless vice captain. He was an alright vice
captain.
Good.
He was good, actually. He was very good.
What I gotta tell you people is, this is only the beginning. That's EPW, right. For so many years, think they have the monopoly on Perth Pro Wrestling? Now it is Chris J. Lazarus Wrestling. This man right here, give me a handshake, brother. That's right here. This man is a champion. That's right. Taylor King, Jay Taylor. It doesn't matter who walks out tonight because this man is walking out a mid-year mayhem with the SHWA Championship. That's because he's a hand-picked champion. I know what I see, and I see gold in your sight, brother. Yes, sir. Get out of my sight. That's right. Me, Chris J. Lazarus. You think Bruno Nitro was going to make this all about him? No! It's all about me. I'm the smartest man in professional wrestling, and tonight you just learned it.
You know, I sleep beautifully at night, thanks for asking, but I want to know, how do you all sleep at night? How do the fans sleep at night? How do all of those boys and girls in the back sleep at night? How does every moron on Twitter sleep at night knowing that you are enablers? Jesse Lambert wouldn't be in the position that he's in without all of you laughing and mocking and blowing smoke up his ass. You call me a bully? You're the bullies. You're the ones sharing all of his bullshit. You're the ones goofing off, laughing, poking the bear, but as soon as it becomes chaotic, as soon as that bear bites back, you're all too happy to sit back and watch it all unravel. Even the clap monkeys in production decide to play a little prank on us, playing that, whatever that music was over the loudspeaker. Let me tell you something. TMDK, we're not here to muck around. You pull pranks like that, you're gonna feel every single second of the punishment that follows. What about you though? What was that?
What?
It probably wouldn't have happened that way if you didn't go back and what?
I was checking on the kid. It's nothing. Like, just get over it. It's fine. It's nothing.
All right.
It's fine.
Okay. I get it. That's it. You don't need any more of this. You don't need any more of us.
I wouldn't hold my breath if I was you. Cause I forget, but I'll never forgive you. Don't you know? True friends stab you in the front.
You really think I came back to become tag team champion for you again? I came back for one thing only. That is the SHWA Heavyweight Championship. The Prince of Perth is back!
And now you know, true friends stand you in the front.
WA Wrestling, teamed up with TK at the last show, but the Prince has come back to be crowned king.
Yeah, a shocking turn of events at the last event. We thought that we were going to have a lovely stretch of matches with former SHWA Tag Team Champions, the Royal Tays. Of course, Taylor King, the SHWA Heavyweight Championship, and that's something that didn't sit comfortably with Jay Taylor as he attacked him from behind. That's right, we had quite an absence of action from Jay Taylor. It was a couple of years, in fact, that we saw him last compete in Explosive
in pro wrestling. He made his return, though, to the Southern Hemisphere Wrestling Alliance a couple of months back. And like you said, we thought they were going to rekindle the Royal Tames, but it seems like Jay Taylor had other plans. And I tell you what, my friends, when the SHWA champion walks through that curtain, Fremantle's own Taylor King, this place is going to come unglued.
I can't hear you, Dean Nelson. All I can hear is 300, 400, I don't care how many people in this building, rabid Fremantle freaks losing their absolute marbles over Taylor King.
Taylor King, the SHWA champion, absolutely flying as the young man from Fremantle. Sits atop SHWA and is in the peak of his career so far. He's in the peak of his career and the peak conditioning of his career as well. He's looking an absolute weapon right now. He's draped in the retro Fremantle colours. He's a massive Freo fan, and what a great year it's been for that on its own too. But he's here tonight and he means business, my good man.
You know what this is? This is exactly what professional wrestling is supposed to be about. It doesn't matter if you're EPW, doesn't matter if you're SHWA. This right here, gentlemen, is what pro wrestling is all about. I've got goosebumps on top of freaking goosebumps.
We're at Freo.Social and it's about to become Tame Antle.
Watch this. Boom!
There it is. The Southern Hemisphere Wrestling Alliance Heavyweight Champion. Taylor King, the Dud Machine, Fremantle's own. Where it all began for him. This is where he was born and bred. How much this means to not only him, but also the EPW champion, Julian Ward, to be putting on a show in the place where they grew up. It just means so much. You better believe Taylor King is here tonight.
They should have named this show Homecoming, because that's what it is. Goddamn Homecoming.
We have reached our co-main event for the evening. And it is set for the Southern Hemisphere Wrestling Alliance Heavyweight Championship. And it is set for one fall. Introducing first the challenger step.
Introducing, for your eyes' pleasure, the hardest man, the next SHWA champion, the presenter, Jamie Taylor.
Been a while since I've heard that one, Emac.
I've got chills, and not in a good way.
You got the feels, did you, Emac?
It's a very, very creepy intro. Let's throw it back to Georgie Hamill to do it.
The crowd knows what they want.
He weighed in at 225 pounds, hailing from Fremantle, West Australia. He is the reigning, the defending Southern Hemisphere Wrestling Alliance Heavyweight Champion! Ladies and gentlemen, this is the Dog Machine, Taylor King!
Well, there's no doubt about whose side the crowd is on here tonight. They're all about Fremantle's own dub machine.
Yeah, and this is a classic battle. Anybody who lives in this state knows Perth and Fremantle are not the best of friends. If you're a Perth boy, you come into Fremantle, they're going to let you know about it. And if you're a Freo boy, you go into Perth, they're going to let you know about it there too. This is Perth and Fremantle, man, the classic good versus evil, but we don't know who's who yet.
There you go, you've got the Prince of Perth and Fremantle's own dub machine in this one, and it's all about the SHWA Heavyweight Championship.
Yeah, home ground advantage here for Taylor King. We just got to hope for Taylor's sake, as we spoke about during his entrance. He is in career best form. He does not want to let this atmosphere get to him and get in his head too much. It could become a negative.
all his friends and all his family are in attendance here. Like you said, Alex, this is a homecoming for Taylor King, and he is just chomping at the bit to defend his Southern Hemisphere Wrestling Alliance Championship.
Yeah, I can't believe I'm going to say this, but I have to agree with EMAC here. Taylor King, his friends here, his family are here. He's the champ. He has everything to lose. Jay Taylor, everything to gain. So Taylor King has to be on his game, keep his eye on the prize, and not let the pressure get to him.
That's right. Of course, these guys do know each other so well. Like we said, they're former SHWA Tag Team Champions together. So they're very knowledgeable about what each other can bring to the table here tonight. Should make it a really well-balanced contest, I think, E-Mac.
That's it. And Jay Taylor, on his day, can mix it up with the very best and is an absolute general inside that ring. Intelligent, beyond what he lets on, there's a lot of pomp, there's a lot of circumstance with how he carries himself, but in ring, his IQ is extremely high.
Well, of course, he debuted back in 2005. I'll leave the math to you to figure out how long he's been wrestling for. Former EPW Tag Team Champion two times over, even won the Invitational Tournament once upon a time as well. He's had a hell of a career. And then you look at Taylor King, a man who's just consistently gone from strength to strength to strength. On the EPW side of things, he's a former Tag Team Champion, but in the Southern Hemisphere Wrestling Alliance, former Tag Team Champion and current Heavyweight Champion.
Absolutely. Taylor King started out as a really young man. He was like, 16, 17 when he started. He's grown into the man you see right there before you. And both these guys are in the best shape of their lives.
Yeah, I think a lot of people can get distracted by how well Taylor King has worked to get into the shape he is in. But Jay Taylor, a little break from wrestling, has done wonders for him in immaculate condition as well. So we know if this one goes long, both men will be up for the fight.
Yeah, good tank on both men. Of course, Taylor King here, though, like you said, the home ground advantage is here in Fremantle. This is a man who is all about that Fremantle lifestyle. Massive fan of the Fremantle Dockers as well. I was chatting to him backstage. His actual wrestling trunks are made out of a Fremantle Dockers Guernsey. He's actually had it cut up and made into his trunks. That's how much he loves Freo.
It looks good. I'm just upset there's not a bit more green and purple and red in there, but he's gone for the new school approach.
He went the retro Freo with his entrance gear. That jacket, actually, that retro gear is worth a lot of money now, but that's a story for another time. As right now, some deep arm drags by the champion, letting Taylor King know that this is his house here at Freo.Social.
Absolutely. Taylor King, you can say Taylor King built this house for this event. This is Taylor King's moment to shine. He's not going to let them down.
Jay Taylor taking a moment outside the ring to compose himself. I don't think that's helping, as it's giving the crowd more opportunity to get behind the hometown boy.
That's right, we keep saying it, but I'll say it some more. It's a sold out crowd. We've got standing room at the back, chock-a-block as well, and so many of them here tonight are on the side of the dub machine.
Yeah, deep there with the arm drag. We saw Jay Taylor trying to scurry away, but hence is the strength there of those arms of Taylor King managing to keep Jay down.
And Taylor King, of course, has to be weary, because Jay Taylor does have that experience edge. And experience is something you just cannot teach. And Taylor King, he's no rookie by any stretch of the imagination. But Jay Taylor knows every single dirty trick in the book. And he's even written a few himself.
Well, that would be to his advantage. But one thing Taylor King can look forward to and hang his hat on is the fact that he knows Jay Taylor so, so well.
Yeah, you got to wonder, you know, when you have so many matches together as a tag team, just how much you do actually share in terms of your in-wing strategy, philosophy, and always when tag teams come together, you go, what if? What happens if we were ever to get in the ring? And just maybe Jay Taylor's been holding back in those conversations.
Well, you raise a good point, E-Mac, but Taylor King, ever since Jay Taylor's been away for the couple of years that he left, Taylor King has evolved. Taylor King has got more tricks in his bag than he ever had before when he was with the Royal Tars.
And that's one of the things that I think makes this matchup all the more interesting. And even more of a surprise that Jay Taylor turned his back on Taylor King as well. It just goes to show the ego and the jealousy between what was, at one point in time, a great friendship between both. And that was an amazing launching forearm strike springboard from Taylor King. How about that?
Yeah, and it just also shows how important the SHWA Heavyweight Championship is for their roster. As Jay Taylor tries to hide successfully, stops the momentum of Taylor King viciously on that ring apron.
Spoke about the experience, and Jay Taylor showing it just there.
Yeah, Jay Taylor not adverse to pulling out every stop in the book, I guess you could say. But my goodness, that one hit hard.
Oh, and speaking of hitting the hard, just collided Taylor King's head with the corner of the ring apron. That is going to do horrible things to a man's well-being. As referee Matthew Clark
Wise move from Taylor King. Managed to shift his momentum onto the apron and come back with an elbow off.
How's the agility of Taylor King we're seeing in this matchup so far? He's being a lot more spry and sliding across, hitting springboards. He's upping his game another level here tonight in his home crowd.
Absolutely, the home crowd advantage. The fact that he is the champion and he's on such an amazing role, coupled with the fact that he used to play football.
Oh, well, there's a big boot there from Jay Taylor. That wouldn't look out of place in any centre-half forward line.
Now kicking right between the uprights. Metaphorically speaking, of course.
And Jay Taylor now has Taylor King. He just drops him right on the tailbone. That is going to be painful, my friends. Might look a little easy, but that one's going
to
hurt.
Yeah, especially when you attack the tailbone, you get to that lower body strength that Taylor King needs for his achy breaky necks and his boss man bomb. So if you can take that leverage and that strength out of his game, it's going to make it a lot harder for him to get that decisive maneuver.
Smart move there by Jay Taylor as he's doing things his way. He's dictating the pace and having things on his terms, which I think is his goal from the beginning.
Absolutely. All he had to do is slow Taylor King down, weather the initial storm of the rush of adrenaline that Taylor King would have had coming into this match, and then take control.
Jay Taylor now in control, just laying in there. You go, like you said, EMAC, the tailbone, the lower back. It's just going to be aching like hell for the dub machine as that's not legal right there. His hand's inside the mouth of Taylor King.
Yeah, certainly on Twitter afterwards, people aren't going to go look at that impressive boot to the spine, but he doesn't care about that, Jay Taylor. He cares about getting the result and taking the SHWA Heavyweight Championship home with him tonight.
That's right. If you've ever been in combat sports or just old enough to have a sore back, you know it's going to be very, very painful stuff there that Taylor King is going through right here tonight with the Prince of Perth, Jay Taylor. Like you said, if you're a follower exclusively of EPW, you would not have seen Jay Taylor for quite some time. Like we said, he took a bit of a timeout. He gathered himself, healed up some old wounds, but he is back with a vengeance. And him coming back to SHWA, if he can be victorious in his second or third match back with the company and be on top of that company, it's going to be huge things for the career of Jay Taylor.
Absolutely. It'll put the crown on his head where he thinks it's belonged all the time.
Exactly.
Taylor now full force into the corner. Not letting up as well as he's going again for a remix.
And big launching drop kick boot to the face. Finds its mark on the dub machine. Jay Taylor with a two count. Near fall there by Prince Perth.
And you notice there as well, Mean Dean, even when Taylor King has to kick out, he's exerting more energy and more pressure on that back. So he's not hiding to nothing at the moment whilst he's on the mat.
It's very true. The look on the face of Taylor King says it all. He's in a lot of pain here up against the likes of Jay Taylor. This one is not going to be easy to come back from for the dub machine. Am I right, Alex?
You are 100% correct. But one thing Taylor King has shown in his career, especially over the last 6 to 8 months, is nothing can keep that man down. He may get beat. He may get stopped. But he will not finish. He will not.
I'm having flashbacks of Optus Stadium last night as the Freo chant is going up all around. Freo Social, I love it, EMAC.
What an odd weather phenomenon at the moment. A purple haze is going down here.
Oh, and down went Taylor King onto the knee of Jay Taylor. What a spectacular backbreaker. And it's only gotten a two count right there.
Absolutely. He's going to keep that momentum up. Keep punishing the back like EMAC has been speaking about. And every time he pins him, he's got to put all his weight on him, hook the legs, hook two legs, make Taylor King exert every bit of force to kick out of that and keep his title.
I'm not going to lie, I'm a little bit surprised with how much Jay Taylor is having his way with Taylor King here so far. I thought this would be a lot more evenly matched, but Jay Taylor's managed to get it on his wavelength of doing things, and he's been managing to be able to dictate the pace of this one and not letting up enough for Taylor King to get any momentum on his side. I haven't seen such dominance since North Melbourne getting their ass kicked by Freo last night, EMAC.
There was always a danger coming to Fremantle. We're going to talk about the Dockers because they're having one good year. But that's okay. What is important right now is that Jay Taylor is just using every part of these maneuvers. He's digging with those knuckles, inflicting as much pain as possible on Taylor King, who's clearly on the back foot.
And that's where the experience factor came in that we were talking about earlier with Jay Taylor. He knew he was going to come in here. Everybody was going to be full of piss and vinegar, Taylor King especially. And if he had to weather that initial barrage, like I said, the initial adrenaline done from Taylor King, if he can sustain that and keep himself in the game, then he can have his way with Taylor King, and the experience factor would keep over. And we see what we see now.
Yeah, well, Taylor King is shifting the momentum his way there. An impressive fight back there. Now he's got Jay Taylor by the head and is looking to keep this match on his terms.
That's right. We don't have anyone on the outside, so to speak, in a managerial sense. But Taylor King has got this entire crowd on his side. And I'll tell you what, they managed to will him back into this fight. But Jay Taylor just spun things back his own way. But it's still not enough to keep the shoulders of the dub machine down.
Yeah, Jay Taylor just silenced the crowd there with that lovely maneuver. Not enough to get the three count, but the fans again are trying to get Taylor King home.
And every time Taylor King takes one of these devastating maneuvers that Jay Taylor's dishing out, and make no mistake about it, he's dishing out a lot to Taylor King. This crowd is just willing him back into the competition.
Yeah, that was a lovely ushigaroshi by Jay Taylor, but now he's in the high rent district. He's going to have to take this risk for the belt. Will it pay off?
No, it will not. No water in the pool to steal a line off you, E-Mac. As Taylor King, here we go. Oh-ho! Flipping neck breaker.
Taylor King calls on the crowd to get behind him here. He needs that adrenaline dump here. Oh, lovely high leg boot lariat. It was a bit of a hybrid maneuver for him, the hybrid athlete himself.
It's Taylor King now. He's got the crowd egging him on. Looks like the dub machine's gonna fly as he goes up and over to the outside!
What a screamer by Taylor King in the heart of Fremantle.
Love to see it.
You love to see it, and now referee Matthew Clark starts the count as both men try to recover on the outside. King first to his feet.
That's right, the crowd are just all the way for Taylor King. Loving what they are seeing. And I must say, I do too, if I may be so biased.
This place is rocking. Absolutely rocking.
Taylor now has Jay Taylor where he wants him, and now he's going to try and go to the top rope.
What's he going to do here? Oh, wait a minute. He's fighting out. Jay Taylor goes down, nearly losing his footy as King just elbow to the face.
Yeah, Taylor throwing those elbows.
We're going to see here, oh, European uppercut there by Jay Taylor. Taylor King thought he was going to fly. It's not often we see Taylor King go to the top rope and do any high-flying offense, but Jay Taylor's going to make him pay for such an attempt as he's got him in a double underhook, and oh, suplex off the top rope.
Oh, the butterfly took flight, crash landed.
Crash landed indeed. It took enough out of Jay Taylor as well, but he again goes to the corner turnbuckle. Could be looking for that finishing blow.
Jay Taylor off the rope. No!
This is a no diving zone in this pool, Jay.
Prognosis negative for Jay Taylor on his high flying.
Oh, and down he goes face first into the mat. Taylor King now. What are we going to see? He's got him up in. Oh, there you go.
Cradles him there. Now into a cover. Puts his leg across the throat. Taylor King using those huge quads to his advantage, trying to put the pressure down. But Jay Taylor has the wherewithal to get that right shoulder up.
Just took the air out of Freo.Social, did Taylor King. This sold-out crowd. A little bit quiet from what we've heard so far here tonight, because they thought that was going to be it.
Yeah, Tom Brady level of deflation there. So hopefully Taylor King can get them back on their feet for his sake.
Dub machine going to do here. We're going to see ourselves a bit of achy breaky neck.
Here we go.
No, some achy breaky eyes there.
Rolls through.
Two. Oh, and just like that, it was almost a new SHWA champion.
Oh, single leg grab by Jay Taylor. Locked in tight.
You know where he learned that from? Lance Storm at the Storm Wrestling Academy with Jay Taylor. Trained for 3 months a couple years ago.
Well, he learnt from one of the best. And there you go. Taylor King, though, just makes the rope. Jay Taylor holds on. And, oh, look at that. Putting extra pressure on the lower spine of Taylor King. This will be excruciating. Oh, oh. Taylor King looks like he's about to tap.
Yeah, he tapped his hand on the mat once there.
Oh, that is just a sickening hold there. Single leg crab, a time-tested maneuver there by Jay Taylor. Listen to this crowd erupt as they try to keep Taylor King in it.
Oh, and Taylor King manages to get that arm to the ropes, breaking the hold, and he almost broke his back, did Jay Taylor.
This is some tough, tough offense. Jay Taylor has come here with a mean streak here tonight. He's bringing some savage offense, and it's all in the name of the Southern Hemisphere Wrestling Alliance Heavyweight Championship. Jay knows what's on the line, and he knows what he's got to do to get it done.
Absolutely, but he's got to overcome the heart and the determination and the guts of Taylor King. This kid ain't champion for nothing.
That's right, he fought very hard to get there. He even got himself a victory over his best friend in the entire world as Jay Taylor's locked up now. And here comes the dub machine.
Oh, comes in like a wrecking ball. May have done more harm than good. Clutching at that back, but Taylor of the J variety has not moved.
He's getting the crowd on his side is Taylor King. He's not done yet. He's taken an absolute hammering in this matchup. But he wants to retain.
Oh, boss man!
He's calling it.
Oh, there you go. That lower back. It's taken a lot of punishment here.
Yeah, I think that's the story of this match, man. How much punishment Taylor King's back's taken.
Slammed down by Taylor. Ooh.
That's a vicious knee.
Oh, and some stomps. Just to add injury to insult.
Not giving Taylor King any chance to recover or recuperate. Just big right hands there across the face and skull and shoulder. Raining down fists of fury.
Not too many fans for the Prince of Perth here in Fremantle tonight. This is a very one-sided audience.
It's almost like he walked in with an Eagles jersey on.
Fair call.
If he did that, he might get a game for them this year.
Everybody else is.
I'll allow it. Meanwhile, Jay Taylor back to the action. Saying some choice words to the champion.
Cut. Oh!
He's going for the cutter, but he no.
He got him!
Taylor King retains!
Out of nowhere!
Talk
about knowing your tag team partner. Knows that Jay Taylor likes to go for that cutter to finish. And what a counter into the backslide to retain the SHWA Championship.
Taylor King has gotten the victory and retained his SHWA Heavyweight Championship.
Well, that's our half of the main event. Now your boys, Julian Ward, Mark...
Hold up one second
come
there.
On.
Jay Taylor not taking too kindly to that. Lost fair and square, and now he's lost his temper.
What the hell? Like, Jay Taylor gave it all he got. He put in a hell of a fight here tonight. But he lost, fair and square.
Fair and square. Now, referee Matthew Clark not allowing him to swing that SHWA championship.
Oh, wait.
DK sets him up. Bossman bomb! Deep in the heart of Freo.
Put the exclamation point on his title defense.
And now, let's defer to Taylor King to get his moment.
The winner of this match by pinfall, and still Southern Hemisphere Wrestling Alliance Heavyweight Champion, Taylor King!
Taylor King's star continues to rise. Another big dub for the dub machine. Now, Julie Ward and Marcus Pitt, follow that, friends.
Well, we'll find out in a matter of minutes, but this moment is all about the dub machine. Taylor King successfully defending his title in his home audience here in attendance. Freo Social packed out. One of Freo's finest getting the job done.
We're going to check.
Incoming.
The TAR.
Dub given. There we go.
Big dub for Taylor King here in the sold out Freo Social. And you just know how much this means to Taylor King.
This was a dub of all dubs here tonight, Freo Social, in front of everybody he knows.
You love to see it. And you know the people here tonight are loving it too. What a great moment.
A great moment. He would have felt the world at his feet when he won the SHWA Championship. But it's fair to say this may be the biggest dub of Taylor King's career.
All right, mate. Look, chin up. I reckon that was... Chin up. I reckon that was the best match you've ever had. As a singles match, you did fantastic. There were points of time there where I thought that you might even beat Damien Slater. And the fact that I'm even saying out loud that you might have beaten Damien Slater is inconceivable to me. If you hadn't have been so distracted by Amber, then I reckon
what?
You might have...
Sorry? What did you say? What was that? You said what's something about Amber? Where is she?
Oh, mate, you and bloody... You and bloody Amber.
What? Sorry, I got choked out. I don't know. I'll tell you what, Dan, I had a great dream, though. So...
Ladies and gentlemen, the time is now for your Worlds Collide main event. Set for one fall, this is a singles match for the EPW Championship.
Moves to his arse.
Oh, wait, swallowed what? Away. It's latality position again.
We gotta see another one.
Ward counters! Tombstone! Whoa. Oh, his last whoa. Shot, the huge lariat!
He gets the job done, he retains!
He took Damien Slater's best
oh,
shot.
Oh! Marcus Pitt, what the hell is he doing?
Marcus Pitt attacks from behind, just bludgeoningly. F5!
Marcus Pitt has sent a message to the EPW champion.
Team DK, they've got their target set on you, and they won't rest until they have the EPW Championship within their camp.
Machine right there in the wrestling ring.
And here he is, the EPW champion, the man with the outlaw state of mind, Julian Ward.
Freo.Social has lit up, my friends. They're all about the EPW champion, Julian Ward, ready to defend his explosive pro wrestling championship up against Marcus Pitt. We saw him do the unthinkable when he dethroned Mikey Nicholls for that gold right there. He went through hell to defend it against Damien Slater, and the battle is not going to stop. He has one hell of an obstacle in front of him here tonight.
Well, he's definitely earned his spurs, has Julian Ward. But Marcus Pitt is the toughest challenge of his very short title reign so far. Let's see if he can overcome the odds and walk out of here with the EPW Championship.
Over to you, Jones Good.
Introducing first in this match for the EPW Championship. He was accompanied to the ring by Amber and weighed in today at 210 pounds. He is a former five-time EPW champion representing TFDK, Marcus Pitt! And now, at 205 pounds, he was born and raised in Fremantle! The reigning and defending EPW champion, the outlaw, Julian!
Julian Ward has gone through a run in the last year that has included the likes of Davis Storm, has included the likes of Damian Slater, and has included the likes of Mad Mikey Nicholls, the man who inflicted Mad Mikey Nicholls' first loss since leaving America. So he's beat the best of the best. I think it's time he shows everyone that he is now the best of the best.
That's right, it's one thing to go all the way and win that championship right there. It's another thing to hold on to it. And one man that knows that more than most is Marcus Pitt, a former five-time EPW champion.
Absolutely, this one's going to be a tale of F5 versus Shotgun Lariat. Whoever hits that move first could very well walk out of here the champion. What do you think, E-Mac? What's it going to go down to?
It's hard to bet against Marcus Pitt, the five-time EPW champ. The only person who's ever held it more times is the greatest of all time, Davis Storm. So it's hard to bet against him, but Julian Ward, with a lot of wind up his sails from his hometown crowd, it's going to be a tough one. I'm not brave enough to make a call here.
Speaking about Davis Storm, I know he's in attendance in the crowd tonight watching this one, I'm sure, with a big smile on his face. Explosive Pro Wrestling has come such a long way since 2001. We'd like to thank you for joining us here this evening on this historic night where worlds collide. And these two mammoth men are colliding now. Corner elbow tie to kick this one off. Alex Woden and Eric Mack, this one's going to be something special. Oh, Julian Ward ducks his way out of that one.
Yeah, Julian Ward is a strong individual, but I don't think he's going to win in the strength stakes against Marcus Pitt. So he's going to have to stick and move and make sure that he gets some effective strikes when he's not expecting it, old Marcus Pitt.
Marcus Pitt's very unpredictable. He's very unstable as well. And one thing we've seen in this series of matchups with Gavin McGavin has been that the one thing you can expect is to expect the unexpected with Marcus Pitt. Who can forget that massive brawl that he had with Gavin McGavin at gate one that went all around the arena? That was incredible stuff, and just goes to show the lengths this man will go to try and get victory.
Yeah, and we saw him take down a former EPW champion, Carl Sterry, at our last event as well. So proving that he can out-muscle everybody on our roster when he can take down the man, Carl Sterry.
Now, I might be a Schwa guy through and through, but I've seen a lot of Marcus Pitt matches in my time, and I like to dub Marcus Pitt Superman, because he can fly, he can leap tall buildings in a single bound, and he's as strong and as quick as a locomotive as well. This guy can do it all.
You see him taking the center of the ring there. It's good ring positioning and also showing a bit of dominance over the champion early.
Well, that's the thing. Marcus Pitt definitely has the edge in the experience column. Oh, but Julian Ward, look out. Just spinning around the challenger and letting him have it. The outlaw. Fremantle's own Julian Ward, but look out, this one. Just going back and forth.
This is what a main event is supposed to look like. Just two big, burly blokes punching the absolute crap out of each other.
Hey, look, I'm here for it, and it's all in the name of the Explosive Pro Wrestling Championship. One of the most prestigious.
Oh,
oh my goodness gracious. Did you hear that, Eric Mack?
I could hear that reverberate through our headphones, reverberate throughout Freo Social. And as you say, the EPW Championship, the most prestigious championship in the land. If you're a pro wrestler in Australia, that's the championship you want to hold. And these two men are about to show what you're going to do to put on the line for it.
Now, over my years, I've seen a lot of great bands play in this very venue, Fremantle Social. It has incredible acoustics, but those chops just echo throughout this very building.
Mate, Eskimo Joe doesn't count as a great band, but you're right, those chops, I think I might have peed a little when he hit him that first time.
Oh, wait, he's going to run the farthest carry where we... Oh, he was attempting an early F5 to get this one over and done with. Julian Ward lucky to cut that predicament off as he's going back to work now. And, oh, Pitt goes up and over.
Yeah, good lower body strength there to be able to pivot up and lift up the big Marcus Pitt.
Both of these guys are in tremendous shape, just physical specimens, as fine as you can get. Oh, down goes Julian Ward to the outside. He's got to look out because there's Amber.
Oh, no!
Look at that! Oh, get just delivered a jumping swing DDT to Julian Ward. You've got to be bloody kidding me.
Not just pretty, but deadly as well. Oh, my God, did you see that?
On the outside, the hardwood floor, there's no give there. And that is a huge game changer here for the challenger.
I've seen Amber in Explosive Pro Wrestling for many years. I've seen them eat defeat. I've seen them slap people great eyes, choke over the ropes. She did a springboard swinging DDT onto the hardwood floor. Amber continues to surprise people and showing why she is such a commodity on the outside area there. I'm damn near dumbfounded.
We've seen earlier this year, Olsen, she let the Untouchables sort out their business like men at Reawakening, but as soon as they had that match, she's been laser focused and been much more hands-on about getting the championship back at Team DK.
Oh, another knife edge shot by Marcus Pitt. That's right. Amber was very unimpressed by the matchup that Damien Slater accepted by Jesse Lambert. She said that Damien Slater should only get championship matchups like we saw at Dead or Alive. Marcus Pitt here, championship matchup. She wants her, compadres to have the championship gold around their waist. The people she represents, she wants to be champions. She doesn't want to see silly stuff with Jesse Lambert. She wants to see this. She wants to see Marcus Pitt, Damien Slater headlining shows and hopefully getting championship gold around their waist.
That's right. The only things that these two guys should be doing, Damien Slater and Marcus Pitt, is wrestling for championships, not lowering themselves to some loser Lambert fella. They should be in this ring, main eventing.
Oh, huge shot there from Ward on the outside amongst his many, many adoring fans here in Freo. Marcus Pitt cuts him off though, looking to use the apron as a friend and an enemy for Julian Ward.
That's right. Just dropped him on the outside ring apron. That's as hard as the statue of Bon Scott.
Who's he?
Mate.
I kid. I want to get out of Freo alive.
Fans.
Marcus Pitt, you notice they're a little bit just starting to rebuild now. They kind of took the wind out of the sails of the audience here, Matt.
That's it. The fans were a little bit concerned there for their champion and now realizing that. Oh, look at the ankle twist there.
That is very bad for the EPW champion.
He takes out that ankle. He can't base to things like the Sterling Bridge Slam or the Bomb Valley Death.
Forget about the ankle. He's taking out the hand as well. Marcus Pitt like a surgeon.
This is the most violent game of Around the World I've ever seen.
Man. Marcus Pitt is very cerebral when he gets in the ring. You won't know by looking at him. But between him and Amber, they'll come up with the perfect game plan. Julian Ward is in a lot of trouble here, fellas.
He sure is. The ankle and the hand of Julian Ward would be in agony right now as Pitt goes behind. What are we going to see here?
Oh, hello.
Look out. Single leg crab by Julian Ward.
Same thing as we saw in the last match with Taylor King and Jay Taylor. And that's not a coincidence, ladies and gentlemen. Julian Ward trained at the same place Jay Taylor did. World-class athletes, world-class pro wrestlers.
That's right, spent some time in Canada at the Lampstorm School of Pro Wrestling. Dishing out that single leg crab, but Pitt kicking his way out of it. Just big boots to the face. It's not pretty, but it's effective.
That is just pure strength to use only his leg to change the course and momentum of another man's body. That is incredible leg strength there from Marcus Pitt.
TMDK's own Marcus Pitt. One of the best we've seen in all the years of explosive pro wrestling. Like we said before, there's only one man who's held the EPW Championship more than Marcus Pitt, and that's Davis Storm. If Pitt gets the win here, he will equal the amount of title reigns of the Godfather, which you know is something Marcus Pitt wants to do, Mac.
And especially to do it right here in Fremantle, he will have a grin the size of the cappuccino strip if he comes out of here with the EPW Championship.
You just know, as much as this crowd is on the side of Julian Ward, as much as they are just jumping out of their skin for Fremantle's own Julian Ward, Marcus Pitt would love to shut them up.
Absolutely. Marcus Pitt, once upon a time, was the face of EPW. He was EPW. And if he beats Julian Ward in his hometown, in front of all his family and friends and his neighbours, he will be the face of EPW from now until a very, very long time.
Marcus Pitt certainly not making any friends and family himself with that tirade in the centre of the ring. Doesn't seem to faze him. Julian Ward now trying to get back to his feet.
Julian Ward, of course, he's taken a lot of punishment in this one. But one thing we've seen time and time again by Julian Ward is the fact that...
Oh, my goodness, did you see that?
I was just about to say, the fact that he never gives up, and he just got wiped out there by Marcus Pitt.
The speed there, he's just like a big cat in the jungle there, just preying on the poor Julian Ward in that instance. Now into the cover, in two, and a two count only for Marcus Pitt.
Marcus Pitt, like he was shot out of a cannon, just launched at the EPW champion there. Ward was lucky to get the shoulder up when he did, though.
Did you notice his eyes, though? Did you notice Marcus Pitt's eyes after he hit that move? He enjoys that. That is what he does. He gets off on inflicting punishment and pain. I love Marcus Pitt. I really do.
Marcus Pitt had an undefeated streak of about 2 years prior to losing to Gavin McGavin as Amber lays in the boots on the outside. One loss in 2 years to Marcus Pitt. You know that loss eats away at Marcus Pitt. We saw what he did to Kyle Steria at Dead or Alive EMAC. You know that he just not only wants to rectify that loss, but he wants to get championship gold around his waist, keep things going, and go back to being the best that he can be.
Yeah, for him, that was an embarrassing loss. It was an embarrassing loss if you look at it from a neutral point of view, but it's embarrassed him so much that he now needs to be the top guy in EPW.
That's right, he just dumped Julian Ward over the guardrail into the audience here tonight. Don't get me wrong, Fremantle loves Julian Ward, but they're getting a little bit too up close with him right about now.
Those premium seats getting every bit of the premium action there as Marcus Pitt looks to bring Julian Ward back towards the ring.
That front row.
Oh! Whoa. Is that a brain buster? Did his brain buster him on the outside?
I believe he did. Brain buster on the hardwood floor, my friends. There is no padding, no mats, no protection on the outside there. That is solid hardwood floor that Marcus Pitt just drilled the EPW champion.
And that's now twice that Julian Ward's head has connected with that hardwood floor. First Amber, now Marcus Pitt. He can't be all there in the head right now.
He's got to be rocked. He's got to be rattled.
Well, that boy's on Dream Street if he's anywhere.
Marcus Pitt, full of confidence and swagger right about now, has everything going his way. There you go. Look at the smile on the face of Marcus Pitt as this packed out Fremantle crowd getting behind Julian Ward.
Whoa!
Oh, nobody home.
No, maybe taking a bit too much time there to rub it in the face of the fans here. Gave Julian Ward the opportunity to move out of harm's way.
Marcus Pitt looking a little rocked himself. Oh. Julian Ward now dishing out some big shots.
Yeah, what a left hand. We're getting into gut check time here, people. This is where the real men step up.
You could call it the fourth quarter even.
Oh, yes, where champions are made.
That's right. Ward, though, rolls up Pitt. Close, but not close enough there. Ward's not going to stop. Off the ropes and... power slam!
Didn't hit the power slam the first time. The second time is a charm. Oh! Not charmed enough to walk away with the EPW Championship. Let's not forget as well, these two are no strangers to one another for a period of time. Julian Ward was a part of the Untouchables until he grew conscious, and that was not to the liking of Mark Spitt and Damien Slater.
Yeah, that's right. They kicked him out of TMDK. They didn't like it one bit. And ever since then, there's been nothing but bad blood between them. Damien Slater brought it up prior to the matchup they had at Dead or Alive. You know, Marcus Pitt's probably talking to him about it right now.
Oh!
My goodness.
Oh, ain't no talking there, T. Nelson. He said, what the five fingers say to the face?
Oh.
I'm not sure he'll be able to hear that response right about now either.
God. My.
Have I mentioned how much I love Marcus Pitt?
Marcus Pitt is just another planet's worth of talent. Oh, Julian Ward, though. Not going to take it lying down. Irish whip from the champion. Back elbow strike to the challenger. And another one. Julian Ward, he's hurt. He's in a lot of pain. He's exhausted. But damn it, he's not giving up.
Not giving up, trying to fight fire with fire. And now running all of his body weight into Marcus Pitt. Looking for that Sterling Bridge slam, perhaps.
Well, Pitt's fighting out. Nicely done. Gets him all. Suplex time.
Wait, Ward mixes it up. One second away from retaining his Explosive Pro Wrestling Championship.
And there's the Sterling Bridge Slam right here in Fremantle. Is that enough? Hooks the leg, that's two. And that's not three on this occasion for Julian Ward.
The Sterling Bridge Slam, about as close as we've been to the Sterling Bridge itself for him to deliver that very maneuver. But it's not enough to get the three count against Marcus Pitt. And what will be enough is the question we're asking. And you just know that Julian Ward's asking himself that very question.
The answer lies in the shotgun lariat, my friends. He's taken everybody's head clean off with that. Marcus Pitt won't be an exception if he hits it.
Make a very good point, Woden. He's got to be thinking about that lariat.
Charges in now at Pitt. Pitt up and over to the outside. That back elbow takes no prisoners.
Every little thing that Marcus Pitt does is done with such ferocity and such power and such ill intent. And oh, we've seen this before, and this never goes well for whoever's on the receiving end.
Yeah, fun fact, I actually showed Marcus Pitt this move many years ago and got him to do it on shotgun Tyler Jacobs.
There you go, and looks like referee Maston just got a load of Marcus Pitt there. He's
having a rough night, Maston, but he's working hard. He's been an absolute workhorse tonight.
Credit to him, he's done a good job this evening, but he's just seeing stars right now.
Oh, and surprise, surprise, Amber comes in with a double fist tantrum slap to the top rope, which leaves Julian Ward precariously perched.
That's the difference maker. That's what she does. That's what she's there for, man, making a difference.
She has expert timing every single time, does Amber, as Marcus Pitt has got Julian Ward on that top rope. What are we going to see here?
Superplex rolls through.
Now, that was a super duperplex. Is he on the tippy top?
And now follows up straight away with... Oh, yes. Powerbomb, sit out, middle of the ring. That's two, and it's two and a half this time.
A little close for comfort here, but the crowd applauding immensely because Fremantle's own Julian Ward is still in the contest. The Explosive Pro Wrestling Championship is still with Julian Ward. And that's what they want to see. But damn it, he's up against it.
Absolutely. That looked like the end of the road for Julian Ward, but all credit to him for kicking out of that.
But off the fireman's carry, you know he's thinking about that F5, but Ward just elbowing his way out of the predicament.
Yeah, out of desperation, out of necessity, but Pitt again with that strength. This is just a battle of wills at the moment, and Ward is not going to go quietly into the night.
No, he is not. For every little thing he went through to get the gold around his waist, you know he has to fight that much harder to keep it. And Julian Ward's well aware of this. Like Taylor King, his friends, his family, his associates are all here tonight, and he's got him lined up, and...
Oh!
Tower of London. Is there a tower in Fremantle? Can we name it after this place?
Sure, I'm sure there's something.
There's a lighthouse. Let's go with the lighthouse.
Let's do it.
But let's go with the... A very near... That's 2 3/4 there.
That sure is. The match is still anyone's for the taking. The Explosive Pro Wrestling Championship hangs in the balance here at our very first time at Freo.Social. Such a pleasure to be with you and deliver such amazing action to you. Always remember, follow us on all forms of social media, on YouTube, because you do not ever want to miss action like this that we are seeing here tonight.
Now, these blokes are going hard at it, Dean Nelson, Eric Mack. I've taken my fair share of fun little pot shots at you guys and at EPW tonight, but the fact remains, nobody can doubt how prestigious the EPW Championship is.
Oh, wait, hold on 1 second there. We've got Marcus Pitt feigning interest in the top turnbuckle for Amber to come in.
Oh, put her down, you brute, put her down.
And, oh.
Marcus Pitt to the save. Look out!
Here we go, Julian Ward! No!
Marcus Pitt throws him off the ropes. Oh! Back elbow strike right on the corner of the jaw. Boot to follow up. Oh no! F5! Nailed by Marcus Pitt! Julian Ward just ate an F5!
Oh! And Ward finds his way to the outside. Much to the disappointment of Marcus Pitt. You can see his head in his hands. He thought that would be it, but Ward gets his way to the outside where he can't be pinned.
Smart work by the champion.
That was pure instinct. I don't know about smart, that was pure instinct on the case of Julian Ward. He got lucky that time too.
I tell you what, Julian Ward just made the perfect move there. No, I mean, you could probably count on your thumbs how many people have kicked out on an F5 by Marcus Pitt before. And Julian Ward managed to get himself out of the predicament so he couldn't even be pinned.
Well, Pitt quickly realizes that, tries to get Julian Ward into the ring now, where he knows he's got him in the perfect position to capitalize.
Waffle him again, give him another one.
Right, he's jacking his jaw to this packed out, sold out Freo.Social crowd. Letting him know what he thinks about their hometown hero. Line it up. There you go. Like you said, Woden, going for a second one.
Oh, rolls through. Small package two. Oh.
Near fall by Ward. The look on Marcus Pitt's face says it all. But Ward now, oh, yeah!
Shotgun!
Is this going to be it?
Oh, no, 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 not yet, not yet! How did Marcus Pitt kick out from that?
The only way I can explain it is that it is Marcus Pitt and it's what he does, but I'm as surprised as you are, EMAC.
The gunslinger reached into his holster, pulled out that shotgun lariat, and Marcus Pitt was man enough to kick out. This match continues.
Man, Superman got his shoulder up in the nick of time. Julian Ward, man, he's going to have to dig down deep if he wants to pull this man away.
Both men have gone to what would ordinarily be their finishing maneuvers, but neither has been enough to keep either man down or get this match done and dusted and get themselves the gold. What's it going to take? I don't know, but oh, I think we're about to find out soon enough, my good people.
I'm not sure these two know at the moment.
Oh.
So in the meantime, they're going to throw their full force at one another.
Oh, what a shot. Take a listen. Oh, they're throwing live rounds, my good friends.
Oh, that's the livest of rounds.
Julian Ward, bring him up now into the ripcord. Oh, humongous lariat. One, two, three. Julian Ward retains the EPW Championship.
And the Fremantle crowd goes absolutely wild. They are sold out and they are here for this very moment. Fremantle's own Julian Ward has retained the Explosive Pro Wrestling Championship.
Oh, absolutely, give it up for Julian Ward. That one, he had to dig down way, way, way deep for that. And he came out on top. He deserves that championship. Absolutely.
The gunslinger. The gunslinger takes another victim there on this impressive young EPW Championship reign.
And another TMDK member at that, Julian Ward, is proving that he deserves that EPW Championship. This is a man that if you want to be the best, that is what you got to get through. Because Marcus Pitt threw so much at Julian Ward here tonight that, dare I say, many people would not have come back from. But not only did Julian Ward come back from it, he dished more out and he got the win and keeps the EPW Championship.
For sure, TMDK might stand for the mighty Donnell, but they sure as hell can't beat Julian Ward.
And look at this. This is what it's all about. Fremantle's finest, Taylor King and Julian Ward.
These two men. Forever this night will be forever Freo. Taylor King, the SHWA Heavyweight Champion. Julian Ward, the EPW Champion. Boyhood friends, the boyhood dream. This is a huge moment for King and Ward.
It doesn't get any bigger than this. This is awesome. This is friggin' awesome.
What a historic night. The first ever co-promoted show by the Southern Hemisphere Wrestling Alliance and Explosive Pro Wrestling. And what a way to finish it. With the two boys from Freo holding the gold high. Julian Ward and Taylor King, thank you so much for joining us for this historic night that has been Worlds Collide. On behalf of Alex Woden, Eric Mack, myself, Dean Olsen, thank you so much for joining us. Follow us on all forms of social media, because this has been amazing. And we'll catch you next time.